Michael, I have been absolutely fascinated by tabletop role-playing games since I was just a kid in high school, and no, you may not cast animal friendship on that baby dragon. I don't care how cute you think it is. Unfortunately, we are down a Danica tonight, but we're still gonna have some great fun. It's gonna be a good time. Ladies and gentlemen, from my left to my right, Caelan Jordan, Brian Kelly, Tobin Moss, and Dane Leeman. Back behind the scenes, we have Jake Blanchette and Gina Bowker.
Yeah.
Amazing. Thank you so much for being here. Shout out to our sponsors. Who do we got? Jetpack Comics, where we are live streaming from the game room of Clerics Components, where you will see some incredible miniatures and set pieces for your games. They are in Canada. They are super nice. And find them on Etsy and tell them we sent you and get some minis and stuff. They are awesome. Also, Mugwater. It is a coffee alternative made from mushrooms and cacao and all sorts of good stuff like masala chai. And it's very good for you and it's delicious and I drink it every day and you should definitely go get it and follow the link that we will be providing at some point in this show to get a crazy deal on your first order of mud. There's one more. The Great North! TheGreatNorth.net is a lifestyle, premium lifestyle clothing brand. The stuff's a little expensive, but that's okay because you can go to GreatNorth.net and use offer code LUDO for 30% off your purchase, and 10% of that purchase goes directly towards wildlife and environmental outreach programs, which is awesome.
Good shit.
Yup. Okay.
Michael, what about your customs brand?
Oh, Mossbow Customs. I make all sorts of crazy little dice boxes and gaming accessories and rolling trays and all sorts of things that you can use for your gaming and, you know, anything Clerics Components can't make out of plastic, I'll make out of wood, and it will be grand. Okay, we're good, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's play some D&D. Okay.
Thank you also to the CIA. Sponsored our show today. If you have any information, just call us.
See something,
or email us at lightsupdiceout@gmail.com.
That's not our
email.
Yeah, we are actually a counter-terrorist cell. You blew our cover, so we're going off the air now.
Listen, no one's watching this.
When we last left our heroes, oh boy, they met. They went on a little trip through Timberfell Farms. They wound up near the abandoned Ruggins mine after being chased by a large, scaly, horrifying thing. They explored the mine. They found Skiff the dog, who led them to a wall of mushrooms that they made their way through and entered into a chamber where they were approached by large mushroom people and welcomed to the Mushroom Kingdom. Here we go.
So I think me and Danica had made that save, so I don't know what I've heard.
I made the save.
Never mind, Danica failed the save.
Yeah, you guys don't hear anything, but you do see these massive, stalky mushroom creatures kind of breaking apart from the wall and approaching you. Two of them are about like 10 to 12 feet tall, and one of them looks to be like 20 feet tall. And there are three of them in front of you now.
Terrifyingly large. Philip, behind me now. Shield and mace, on the ready.
Can I also be behind you? That would be ideal.
I'm gonna stand next to him. But I'm not gonna draw my weapons. I'm going to give a diplomatic pose, which looks like, what is a diplomatic pose?
That's like a mime, I think.
I am trapped in a wall of diplomacy.
The largest mycenid kind of shakes his big head, and you see this cloud of spores just off of him. And the both of you, I'll have you roll another wisdom saving throw.
I got a one.
Five.
Awesome. So, from absolute silence, you hear, "Hey, what are you doing in our domain? What has brought you all to the Mushroom Kingdom?"
I'm looking for my goat. I can't speak for the rest of them.
There is a young lad that we're searching for.
Oh, right.
This is his dog.
Right, dog. Goat guy. I'm sorry, what was in that?
Oh, all will be revealed when you go to Shangri-La and eat of the All Spore.
It seems like it gets worse when I cover one nostril.
Don't fight. It'll be fine.
No, I don't want
famous last words.
My name is Hendrix, and this massive 12-foot tall mushroom gestures to himself, and he gestures to another one, and you hear a very similar voice say, "And I'm Garcia." And the last one, the big tall one, kind of shakes again. He says, "I'm Weir."
Weir?
Weir.
Weir what?
Weird.
Weird.
Weird
mushrooms. We must take you to Shangri-La.
So are all of you together?
What do you mean?
Like, are all of you together?
Seems like a very like when personal four, question.
This is just what is coming to mind to ask, and I feel like that's sort of attacking me a little bit.
Mortals are very funny. There is no time to dawdle. You must come with us to Shangri-La.
I see no downside.
Have you been paying attention?
Did you happen to escort a teenage boy to Shangri-La?
And a goat?
Recently?
Have you seen my goat?
Teenage is very young. But there was a human. All will be revealed when we take you to Shangri-La. And I don't know of a goat.
Oh.
But we must take you to Shangri-La.
Seems
sketchy.
Well, but they seem so convincing.
Do they?
Also, well,
feel free to roll an insight check.
20-foot tall dude.
I feel as though that enormous thing could have crushed us already.
Mm-hmm. What's going to happen if we say no?
Well,
I would imagine all will not be revealed.
Suppose there will be an easy way and a more difficult way. But now that you have entered our domain, we must take you to Shangri-La.
Let's go the easy way.
Yeah, I like
the easy way. I love the easy way.
Do we walk there?
Seems like,
or
is there like a...
All right, but it's not my fault that you get squished by massive mushroom men.
Can we get there by ourselves? Like, do you need to take us there? Or can we just, like, meet you?
Yeah, just give us, like...
We must take you to Shangri-La.
All right. Can we have a quick huddle?
All right, stand behind the big man covered in steel now.
All right.
Follow. And the massive, weird mushroom kind of gives you this gesture to follow. And as they turn, a wall kind of recedes of mushrooms and opens up into another staircase that leads down. Also eerily lit by these glowing mushrooms on the walls.
So they seem nice.
They don't seem mean.
Nice is a relative term.
Well, let's see where they're taking us, and then we'll know.
Oh, I'm going. Yeah, 100%. Yep. Let's do it.
Okay. Hey, I guess we're all in on this.
Be revealed.
Hey, I'm behind you, buddy. We don't need any more revealing. I didn't realize mushroom men
when
had
you say all. I'm just following behind at this point. Like, when you say all, do you mean like...
Like
I have some things I'd like to see.
Mind-blowingly all, or most.
So the winding steps eventually open into an impossibly large cavern, entirely covered in vibrant, softly glowing mushroom caps.
Up or down?
Down.
Thank God.
Yes.
I don't need a better view.
Veins of light pulsate gently through the network of fungus enveloping the walls and ceiling. Where are we? Got you. Hendricks and Garcia lead you through a bustling street populated by mushroom people of all shapes, colors, and sizes. Short, stout mycenids about 2 feet high zip by you with bushels of rooted greenery. Massive, stringy mushroom stalks 20 feet high pull trees through the walls of the cave by the roots. The city moves fluidly, and its people silently coordinate, never missing a beat. The street eventually leads to a set of towering wooden doors, covered almost completely in moss and fungus, guarded by a massive mycenid. And Hendricks raises his hand, he goes, "Hey Floyd, gotta take these people to Shangri-La, you know, how it goes." And this massive 30-foot-tall mushroom goes, "Okay." And he steps to the side and holds up his hand. And the imposing wooden doors part to reveal a chamber lit more brightly than any space you've seen down here. At the center of this circular chamber sits a massive pile of mushroom caps, heavily pulsating with ever-shifting light. Just in front of this marvel is a tree, barren, except topped with a shapeless mass of bark, fungus, and moss, apparently connected to thousands of roots dangling from the ceiling of the cave. "This is Shangri-La." And he ushers you through the door.
I gotta say, underwhelming.
What I wouldn't give for some boiling water.
You guys go in?
Yeah.
Let's be
fine. Yeah. Absolutely.
They seem to trust
that we don't trust anymore. Mm-hmm. I mean,
seems like a bad plan, but okay.
Where's the... I mean, you guys clocked the exit, right?
Yeah, the way we came in. Okay. That door that we could definitely open.
So those doors are starting to slowly close behind.
Hey, we just gotta grab something before we have an audience in Shangri-La. We just gotta...
It's okay.
Did we just get trapped in the Spencer's gifts?
You hear a voice say, "Who is Spencer?"
We don't know him. Did he do something wrong?
There's a young boy. We're looking for a young boy.
A young boy named Spencer?
Yeah. Right?
He might answer to that name among others.
Maybe like Spencer, like Spencer.
We don't know a Spencer. And you guys hear this like crackling and creaking, and you see the tree in front of the pile of mushrooms starts to shimmy and shake a little bit, and the mass up top unfolds into the largest mycenid you have seen yet. And he looks a little something like this.
Oh man, you're gorgeous.
Oh.
It's like a street
shot. I don't mean to say it. I'm not saying that lightly. I've seen a lot of mushrooms in my life and...
Oh, I didn't mean it about the boiling water. Totally did not. That was just, it was, I'm nervous. It happens when I'm nervous. When there's 50-foot-tall mushroom people.
So yeah. as he very gracefully, surprisingly gracefully, dismounts from the top of the tree, he unperches himself and quietly lands ever so gently just in front of the tree and takes a massive hand and rips it out of the ground and brandishes it like a scepter and says, "I am Shangri-La."
Oh. That's way better.
Okay. What are your pronouns, if you don't mind my asking?
Same voice.
It's a very similar voice. My pronouns. I am a mycenid. You may call me Shangri-La.
Shangri-La. Okay, so we're just going with the noun, Shangri-La. Hey.
Alright.
My name is Avitus Beam. I am leading this expedition.
Are you?
I am leading this expedition.
Okay,
And
I believe you believe this to be true.
So we're on that together. Half elf and what did you say, Mycenid?
Mycenid.
Mycenid. Interesting. Haven't heard it. Anyway, my party. This is introduce yourself.
I'm Minka. Hi.
I know.
Oh, that's weird. Mm. I don't like that.
I am Reginald Wilberforce Buckshot or Harcourt.
Yes.
Changer.
I know.
Mm. A pleasure to meet you.
Who do you think I am?
Who do you think you are?
You are a troubled soul looking for adventure to soothe your need for revenge.
He's gonna... We even need to break him open to get that fortune.
It would be very difficult for you to break me open.
Oh no, it was a metaphor.
Why would you say that?
It was a metaphor.
Stop threatening the giant mushroom man.
They have a name. It's Miasid.
Please. It is Shangri-La.
Shangri-La.
It's Shang.
Not just one of them, it's a Mycenid.
No.
There's multiple.
They're not Mycenids.
Mycenids? Mostly.
Forgive us, Your Excellency Shangri-La.
Oh, please. There is no need for flowery titles. I am simply Shangri-La.
But you're the biggest.
I am sizable.
We're here in the room with you, buddy. You're 40,
there may be my kind operates across a vast network encompassing the entire planet. And we are many, and we have been here a very long time.
I'm gonna do a nature check real quick.
Set with the talking slow, because the sound doesn't pass. It's okay.
Is my speech too slow for
No, it's no, perfectly the right speed.
Perfect. Here in the Mushroom Kingdom, we like to chill.
I do not want you to be hasty or angry.
You have recently experienced difficulty in battle. All of your years of training and practicing could not prepare you for your own ego.
I may have left before I leaped. Looked before I always get those wrong.
Perhaps moving forward in your adventures, you will consider tactics.
Ah.
This is some eye-opening advice. Who knew the mushrooms could open your inner eye to the secrets of the universe?
Huh.
Hey, wait a minute. Are you just telling us what we want to hear? What about me? Do me.
Forget the girl.
Oh. What girl?
Oh, it worked.
More importantly.
He's really good.
More importantly, you have found something in yourself. Years of study could not prepare you for praxis, but you took it in stride and made a great leap. You took your first life.
Yeah, I was a goblin, but...
All life is sacred.
Wait.
In our defense.
But they came after me, so is that okay?
Yeah.
We recognize the balance of all things. Mm. The cruelty of nature. All of it. The good with the bad. We understand. This wasn't easy for you. It will weigh on you. But it should not discourage you, for your path is long and great. And you don't like working with others.
Not these others.
We could have told you.
He's not that bad. He's not that bad.
Perhaps
handy in a pinch.
Communication and teamwork may be things for you to strive towards.
Speaking of, how are you talking to us without a mouth?
He kind of shakes and all of these spores release from his back and kind of coat the room in spores.
I just brushed off the last bits. You know, lace.
We speak through our own children. We send them from ourselves and into you, and we communicate with them.
So they're inside of us?
I may be ill.
For now, your bodies cannot sustain their life.
Oh,
and
God, I
they
hope
will
not.
Pass harmlessly from you.
But while you are with us
and near us, you can hear our thoughts and we can hear yours.
Oh my God,
you can hear my thoughts?
Oh, don't think about that.
I've eaten his children. I'm not well. I may be sick.
Pull it together, Reggie.
Okay, but
I step forward and I say, Mr. Shangri-La, sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Do you know where Petunia is? I really miss her, and I really want to find her.
The goat with four horns.
Yeah, is that a weird thing?
Petunia.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Petunia.
It is.
That was a good one.
I made it last session. It doesn't count.
I have not seen this goat.
But
your goat is,
I'll say, dead.
Alive.
Okay.
It's not dead.
It's not dead. That's good.
He kind of takes a couple steps towards you, and there's a couple more wounds kind of like sticking out of his back that he just kind of like unplugs from. And he goes, the forest knows when you are there.
That's terrifying.
It feels you. It sees you. It hears you. And it tells me about it.
Okay.
So I had had that bad mutton, and I had to go. You saw that.
In a manner of speaking, fear not, little one. We are...
Forget I ever brought it up.
...private beings. So there is a reason you've not heard of us before.
Beast Boar.
So you see us when we're waking and you see us when we're sleeping? Do you know when we've been bad or good?
It is not for me to decide what is bad and what is good.
Very good.
I hate to be this person, but she didn't answer my question.
Judgment.
Your impatience and rage will be your downfall.
Okay.
She doesn't.
Unless you can channel it into something productive.
Ready, stay and calm down.
I do not have all of the answers you seek.
So you don't know where Petunia is?
I do not.
Okay.
And the boy that ran in here, do you know
man.
Where he is? The man.
Boy man.
The young boy man. My age.
The human.
Right.
Yes.
Yes, none of us are that, except
fleshy bag of bone.
Yes, sorry.
You are a...
Human.
Very small human.
I know.
I mean no offense. I am very large.
It's true.
Oh, I hadn't noticed.
A little intimidating.
Thank you.
If I'm being honest.
Can I ask, you said there was a reason we hadn't heard of you before. Is there a reason we're hearing of you now?
You entered our domain. Long ago, the humans built a mine. And this mine was dug and dug until they broke into our domain.
They dug too greedily and too deep.
And so, we gifted the humans with our magical knowledge so they would stop digging into our world. Mm-hmm. And we sealed off our domain once again until Human Boy stumbled in.
Are you mad about that, or just trying to gauge safety-wise?
We were not mad.
Okay.
He ate of the Allspore, and his intentions were true.
Ooh.
Just about this Allspore. It sounds like a large thing for you. Can you give us a bit of a primer? We're just unfamiliar.
And he steps to the side and gestures at the massive tower of glowing mushrooms behind him.
It's like all of the spores.
He says, this is the cornerstone of our civilization. The Allspore was born in the Age of Darkness. And it connects and binds all of our kind across the world. Its caps grow in every Mycenaid city in the Mushroom Kingdom. And it is where our magic comes from.
May we negotiate?
We should not anger these people.
No.
You think?
Xanadu. Not Xanadu.
Kublai
Khan. Shangri-La. Honored Shangri-La. Might you point us in the direction of the human that brought such disturbance to your kingdoms? And we'll happily extract him.
Wait,
and get out of your hair, so to speak.
Did he eat of the Allspore without your permission, or with your permission?
No. All who enter the Mushroom Kingdom must eat of the Allspore.
Oh, I'm allergic to mushrooms.
I was afraid.
I ate right before we got here.
I'll do it.
Those who refuse will be sacrificed to our protector.
You got like a little mushroom there, like a snack.
Salt or paprika? I mean, just straight, straight up. Salt. Like, we don't cook it first. Hmm. Okay. I mean, I'll give it a go.
And he just mindlessly kind of reaches behind him and plunges his hand into the Allspore and just pulls out this, like, mass of mushroom meat that is still kind of, like, pulsating this orange-yellow glow. Oh, okay. And he, like, in his fingers just breaks off a little piece and... Of course, this to him is like,
It's
I mean, all
the whole thing.
One must just take a bite.
We can handle a bite.
I'm doing it.
I take a bite.
Okay.
Everybody, roll a wisdom saving throw.
Be the babysitter.
That would be a 19.
Ooh.
18.
Ooh.
14.
Ooh.
15.
Ooh. Number to beat was 20. okay.
This game.
So a couple of things are going to happen. First of all, the mushroom tastes like sweet, like a fruit. It almost like bittersweet, like an apple, but a little more earthy. It's quite good. And you feel this as soon as it enters your mouth, you feel this warmth overtake your body. And you can still see normally, but as you look at each other, all of your eyes are just white and kind of like glowing a little bit.
And if your eyes are white,
Dude, your eyes are totally white.
Your eyes are totally white.
What does my tattoo say?
Dude, where's my...
Right. Now, so like as you guys are getting used to this like warm feeling, the room just starts kind of like pulsating a little bit, like coming in and out. Things start looking like they're breathing.
Is it supposed to do that? Is that normal?
I'll take another bite.
Why would you? Okay.
And now let me ask you guys a very real question. Does anybody mean to do the Mycenids harm?
Absolutely not. Specifically, that really tall one. That really dates right out.
Okay.
I mean, this is probably appropriate size, and no.
Okay.
No.
But I'm just thinking about my charges a little bit.
Yeah.
And only if I feel like they mean me harm.
No, Philip, eat some of this.
Yeah. Philip starts tripping.
It's
stacked, dude.
And
a couple of minutes of this go by. Where I mean, like, it could be hours, it could be minutes, you guys don't know. But
sure.
you're just kind of, you're very comfortable, and things are just kind of weird. And then, as quickly as it came on, just kind of subsides. And Shangri-La is standing before you, and he says, "Okay, you're cool.
You're cool, man.
You're cool. I love you guys. Yeah, so we can't really release the other human, though. I'm sorry, bros. It's just, you know, he broke one of our rules. He tried to free the prisoner." And
there's another prisoner?
Oh.
We didn't get around to that.
Please explain.
Philip, put the mushroom down. Come on.
Come with me. And he holds up his tree, and the massive doors reopen.
Doors are open. That's good.
And you can see through the doors. You know, the Mushroom City is still doing its thing. And
it's not the door behind us. It's the door. We're going further.
Well, you're going back into the Mushroom City.
Back.
Yes. So he starts leading you through with his tree as a walking stick, and as he leads you through the city. And as you walk, he says, "You see, the Mycenids have been a part of this ecosystem since the old gods were around. They were. But they left us alone. They only disliked mortals. Now, we have forged many bonds with many civilizations over the course of this time. And one of those has been with the artificers of Nikolai." You guys roll a history check.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. 13. I remember that. Yeah.
Okay.
30, 20.
Nice.
15.
Okay.
18.
Okay, yeah. You guys would all have a general understanding of the Clockwork City of Nikolai is, if we want to bring up the world map, the Clockwork City of Nikolai is on the southern tip of Cromnia. It is legendary. It is supposedly inhabited by gnomes and elves and dwarves, even though the rest of the continent of Cromnia is strictly humans. It is a marvel of technology, and pretty much everybody who lives there is an alchemist or an artificer. And they make things. They create new technologies and potions and poisons and whatnot. Very smart people. And he says, "They have had issues with their neighbors to the north, and they have devised quite a system to keep out intruders, including some portals." And Shangri-La walks you down this descending staircase that takes you into a massive chamber of prison cells. All natural rock formation with vines and mold and fungus all growing on them. And you can see, like, on one side there is a vast, long cell that could house hundreds of people. And in the top corner of this cell is a portal, just glowing this dark black purple energy and swirling. And you see an unconscious person in some rags laying on the floor in the large cell. And there are more cells that are small individual cells that just go down for hundreds of feet.
So from what we know about our target, is this our guy? Can we tell?
The young boy. We're looking for the young boy.
This is our prisoner. He came through the portal. Anyone who comes through the portal wearing the robes of Cromnia will be sacrificed to our protector, the dread beast, Flopsy.
Well, I think we may have encountered Flopsy.
That's as may be. But the young boy most certainly did not come through the portal.
So no.
I'm sure there is some way for us to redress these matters.
You see, he tried to free the prisoner, and this is sacrilege.
Well, but he's a kind-hearted lad, obviously.
Do you know this lad?
No, but he sounds that way. Doesn't he, then?
Yes, his dog's rather fond his of him. His dog dogs is are very excellent friendly. Judges of character.
He's just right back up there.
Excellent judges of character.
He's a good kid. How's
it going? I mean, Skip is still with you guys. Skip is, yeah. Is kind of...
Did Skip eat the mushroom?
Skip did not eat the
mushroom. Oh, man.
Oh, no, you can't. That's
you can't.
He's not food motivator.
No mastiffs were hurt in the making of this episode.
Yeah. All right.
Did the boy say why he wanted to rescue the prisoner?
He didn't need to.
But he's in... But this is the prison.
I will take you to him. And he walks you, he starts walking down this hall. And Devin, if you'd like to take your mini and your place at the table.
Mm-hmm. Wow, so perfect timing. Hey! What's going on, guys?
So, as he walks you down this prison row, you see in the last cell, kind of sitting against the wall, a human looking to be about 20-ish years old, in some ragged hunting clothes. And just outside the cell is a mushroom stalk that is hollowed out and has a bow, quiver, a short sword, some general adventuring gear, and it is just out of reach of the cell.
The sweet bow.
And the dog, Skiff, runs up to the cell and starts yapping.
So, Mr. Xander.
Shangri-La!
Mr. Shangri-La.
Stop it.
We have been tasked with retrieving what is typically this boy. This blonde-haired, beautiful boy.
That's a little weird.
This delicate, cherubish. Is cherubish a word?
Yeah.
All right.
Say it confidently.
We would very much like to take him home. Is there something we can do to secure his release?
That was a weird way to phrase that, Abby. Because, good God.
This
they boy. Don't like those adjectives.
Mm. This human broke our laws. His fate is yet to be decided.
What if we cut our losses and we leave?
Oh, no! Shit.
No. Boy, are they treating you all right?
I'm petting my dog. I'm
yeah, yeah, you are.
I'm giving him
oh,
love.
He's conscious.
And I snap their attention and I'm like, what?
Are they treating you all right?
Sir, do you see my surroundings?
But have you been tortured?
Do they feed you?
But weird Mushroom Kingdom prison aside, all other things being equal.
It's just mushrooms.
It is just mushrooms. All
right. We're on it. Certainly there is some way that we can, like I said, redress this situation. Certainly there is something that we can do for you that will allow you to give him some sort of reprieve.
By reprieve, we mean he comes with us.
What if we guarantee he receives punishment on the surface world when he returns there?
And banished. Never allowed to return again. You could befuddle his mind with your little children's spores.
Oh, God. Roll a persuasion check. Yes. Yeah, let's say, who's got the higher charisma? Because you're both doing it.
That's, I mean...
Yeah, so we could do this one of two ways. You can either both roll persuasion, or one of you can roll with advantage.
I mean, that's a dirty... I'm sorry, that's a dirty... it's a 22.
Go for that, yeah.
Okay.
As the leader of this expedition, I would like my friend.
I still believe... You still believe that to be true. What kind of punishment?
A thorough spanking by his father when he gets home, I'm certain. But to redress this, I mean, he'll never return, will you, boy? Never return.
To this place?
Yeah.
No.
Exactly. See? So he will never darken your... moldy doorstep ever again.
It's
what we call
that's a mental fault. I wouldn't
know. It's what we call in diplomacy a back end dinner.
The giant mushroom man, Reginald.
I must ponder. Sorry. And he takes the tree and slams it against the ground, and he and the tree turn into mist.
Oh.
Than how he had it.
This is why Reggie's not allowed to talk anymore.
I think just that's saying. The mushroom.
Do we have a route of exit, or can we get him out?
Have we been talking to nothing this whole
time? I mean, let's talk to this guy. Maybe he's a total dick. Maybe. So why did you try to free that prisoner?
Wait. Is he the prisoner human as well?
Yes.
Okay. Just making sure. It's a man trapped in a cell. What would you expect me to do?
But
are you familiar with the concept of prisons?
I mean, bad people do bad things.
Are you familiar with the concept of mice blurs?
No.
Only for the past 10 minutes, yeah. This is new territory for all of us.
However, we did. Have you eaten?
It might have been a few hours.
Is he a friend of yours? Do you know him?
I know not. Why do I have this beard? Okay. How long have we been here?
Mycin, it's gone. Y'all are just. Oh, you're talking about...
I'm talking about the person.
The guy in the cell. Yeah. You don't know. But you can hear now, coming from the other side of the cell, you can hear, please, before he comes back, please.
Yeah, but we mustn't involve ourselves in these situations. He has been put...
Yeah, what are you in here for?
Please, come closer.
Sorry, I didn't mean...
Please. Utmost importance, please.
What did you do?
I did nothing.
He is an obvious scoundrel.
So,
if
you guys get closer to him, you will notice that he's wearing some very fine clothes, dirty, as if he has been in this cell for a couple weeks.
Are they Cromian?
Roll a history check.
Hell yeah, I got it.
Yeah. Black robes with a gold, steeple on the front. It is 100% Cromnian.
He's Cromnian.
Avi, we cannot...
Of course I'm Cromnian. I can hear you.
No, I can smell his balls from here.
We are not going to get the young lad...
Who is my age?
The young lad out...
Our age.
If we're helping this one.
Yeah, please. If we're helping one person, it's the dog boy.
You must listen to me, please. I am Baron Zurich von Erlo of the Cromnian dynasty.
You say that like it should mean something to us.
Yes, of course it means something.
Say that like I like barons.
But it doesn't mean anything to me.
How did you say dynasty?
Do not speak to me, filthy half-breed.
All right, so we're not going to free him, right?
Listen, you're a human, you must be reasonable.
Our compatriot is also human, and if you would show her the same respect, that would be great. Also, I'm a half-elf, so, like, half-respect.
Silence, half-breed. You're a human.
Lex Pacifierat.
What? Me cheating that I'm... to be a human.
Lex Pacifierat.
I'm gonna kill him.
Hey, doctor.
It's my house sigil.
My name's Ewain.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
We're gonna call you Spencer for the rest of this. Just go with it.
Wait a minute.
Wait, what's your real name?
As long as you get me out of that.
That's an Ironheim name. Harcourt.
Yeah.
Why are we entertaining this asshole?
Why are you so far from Ironheim? How are you here on Cromnia?
It is, in fact, we that are there, but you are here.
What?
You, that big, swirly, dark, purpley, scary thing up in the corner over there. I would imagine you fell through it.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. No. Except I'm not your dear.
Listen, I must speak to the artificers of Nikola. They must take this missive to whoever can help. Please.
Who can help about what?
A missive now.
Yeah, miss me with that.
You have a letter.
He reaches into his robes and he pulls out a little glass vial with a scroll in it. And he says, I cannot tell you.
By my word and on my house, I shall make sure it is delivered for you.
This missive may only be opened by one of the five kings of Marlovia.
But, I mean, then give me their names, boy. I can't help.
I feel like we know those names.
Oh, yeah, you definitely know the five kings of Marlovia. King Gavin is the Lord of Ironheim. right.
I mean, I'll do what I can. I'll give it to my father, and he'll send it off on some griffin or crow or something. I don't know.
This must be taken to the king's hands directly. I cannot trust this to go into the wrong hands. The fate of the world could be at stake.
I've already given you my word that I would pass it along.
What happens if none of the kings get this scroll? Just saying, if we leave you here to rot, what happens, theoretically?
The world ends.
Yeah, well, you know, that's not...
It's gonna happen anyway.
Exactly. So why...
Within the next year...
Are there other scrolls, or were you the only one sent out with a scroll?
That's worse.
I wasn't sent with a scroll. I defected.
Oh.
Yeah, okay.
I went looking for the artificers to deliver the missive so they could bring it to the right hands, to one of the kings of Marlovia.
I'm going to insight against his bluff, but just in case you have one.
Sure.
Rolling at the one again.
As you're, like, trying to pay attention to him, you hear, like, some droplets coming from behind you, and you're like, oh, that's fun.
Not all spores, got lingering.
You're just coming down from the shrooms, man. It's fun.
He's not trustworthy. We'll bring this.
Unless you have someone else that you think is coming. Particularly a lord who will give you his word that he will take your missive and send it along to whoever it is you want me to send it along to. I am not going to Markovia. I have a young lad to return to his father, and then an Avi to deliver to the Winterfell farm so they can talk about wheat. My dad cannot, is full, sir.
If you cannot bring this missive directly to the king, then the world is doomed. I cannot trust anyone else.
Well,
and
then...
you are the only people here.
Let me... Sidebar. You can come.
I'm in the cell!
He was talking to the dog.
I need to remind you that if we ruin this and the giant scary mushroom men catch us, we're gonna die.
They
we're
don't
be...
want him out.
We're gonna be sacrificed.
We don't want him out.
I don't want
Nobody
to be a mushroom
him.
Sacrifice. I just want to fight Petunia.
However, parley and safe conduct are things that we as nobles guarantee one another. So, I mean, If he has a missive that needs to be sent along, I am duty bound.
He doesn't listen to anybody except himself, does he?
If we take a missive to the king, I bet the king will give you like 3 goats.
What? How do
I mean, there are spells that will track things.
I don't want 3 goats, I want Petunia.
I have, I have a grand.
Yes, 6 horn goats.
So
I mean, that's a pretty plan.
I understand as a middle manager that if I bring back any sort of intelligence from Promnia, that it's gonna look good for me if I also accomplish these other tasks.
What is your station, half-breed?
So I am a comptroller. Are you familiar with a comptroller?
He doesn't even know how to pronounce artificer, bro. I don't think he knows.
Cromnia.
It might be like in Cromnia you say.
Did I not try to
administrator or what is another dumb word for what you guys might do? A
Can you guarantee? I've stopped listening to you. Can you guarantee the safe delivery of this missive to the king?
I can guarantee my hardest effort.
The world will end. You don't understand.
I might get fired. You don't understand.
you hear this like.
He's coming.
Quick.
Mist, sorry.
No,
the mic this.
We gotta take it now or never.
The master is.
I promise.
He slaps it into your hand, and as he does, you feel this sharp burning sensation in your hand, and this mark transfers from his arm onto yours.
God damn it. Is it a cool mark at least?
It looks like, it looks like the Cromian Citadel, but there is like a serpent wrapping up the Citadel.
God. Good
kind of
hell, that's awesome.
Some
good
kind
news.
Of dark mark.
You got high on shrooms, you got a tattoo.
What a session.
Big facts. So now you have a sigil on your forearm.
Oh, I roll my sleeve down like real fucking fast.
Yeah. And the mist takes the form of Shangri-La once more, and he says, "There is an issue." And you can see like the mushrooms on his shoulders start to like glow red. And then all of the mushrooms lighting the halls transition from purple to red. And he says,
"Is it a fire?
There is forbidden magic being used on the surface."
On the surface?
Not here.
We should get up there and take care of that for you.
Yeah.
How about as a favor, we take care of the forbidden magic on the surface, and you let us take Dog Boy.
And he'll help us.
My name is Ewain.
Wayne.
Ewain.
Spence.
Not the Wayne.
Were they
the Welder the Wayne?
Any Wayne you have.
You're fired. Session's over. Hey, everybody dies.
Man, I thought Dane was going to be the first one to get
fired. We will. As the leader of this party, I can guarantee that we can take care of whatever aberrant magic is on the surface for the Mushroom Kingdom. And yourself, Lord Xanadu.
Shangri-La.
And we won't tell anybody that you were the ones who sent us up there to do it.
Absolutely. With Mums the...
Roll a persuasion check. With advantage. Anybody.
Me?
Yeah, anybody. You're all helping out, so.
18.
Okay. Shangri-La said, "You are proficient with a bow, a skilled hunter. You may accompany them, but you will all return. Oh. I will keep," and he holds down his hand, and Skip kind of runs over to his hand, and he scoops him up, and a cage of vines kind of folds over Skip, and he, "I will keep the dog." And he
looks over to the corner of the room where your dark elf companion, who has been very quiet this session, says, "And we will spend some time with your druid." Mm. And a cage of vines just over Ellesandra.
Ellesandra, you're good with this, right?
I assume she says yes.
Yeah.
Skip is not, though. Skip is losing his mind. Skip's losing his mind, dude. He's freaking out.
Just got reunited with me, and now he's taken away again.
Yeah, and he waves his hands. And he waves his hands, and the prison, the cell door just kind of like recedes, leaving you to take your gear.
I'll go over and pick up my gear.
Yeah, cool.
I'm gonna
examine him. Is he in full health? Is he like able to?
Coming down from a shroom high, but yeah. Otherwise, I mean, like they have kept him fed. They have kept him. You know, alive and healthy. There's been no torture, no beatings or anything. So he's, you know, he's a person who seems to be in good health.
So you can shoot.
Yeah.
All right.
Can Philip stay with the dog?
Yes. A child's place is not in combat.
Correct, sir.
There's a child.
No, this seems fine. This seems fine. He's gonna live to be 12. Okay.
Where's the Philip?
13.
He is making 12.
Philip's like, I can play with a dog!
13. Exactly.
Mr. Chamberlosser, I have one more question before we leave.
Is it about Petunia?
No.
Okay. Continue.
What? Do we know what kind of forbidden magic is on the surface? Just to prepare a little bit.
Something is being summoned.
Is it right above us? I ask him so many words.
Not far.
Is it
to the north? And he like holds his hand up to the wall, and these like roots come out of the wall and kind of wrap around and sink into his arm, and he goes 600 meters north.
That's very specific.
And
that's a lot more specific.
Kind of let go, and the roots recede back into the
We don't need a carriage. I think we can just walk that.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Please, there is no time to waste.
Let's go.
Is there a door or a passage or?
He gestures back the way through the
way you guys came. I would assume.
Hey, follow us. We've been.
Oh. I'm just trailing along.
So,
missing my dog.
Oh yeah. Whenever you guys eventually breach the surface, it is sundown. It is dusk.
Oh.
Yeah, you guys have been in there for some time.
Now I am going to. I'm just actually going to start walking 600 meters north. I'm going to save this.
Right. Y'all just heading straight there.
Move stealthily?
Not for 600 meters.
Can I summon the Funyuns?
Funyun summon.
Summon Funyun. Funyun.
It's a cantrip.
Yeah. That's a good cantrip.
Summon the Funyun.
It's more useful than half of them.
It's true. Some utility spells are garbage, man.
You get a half ration.
What is True Strike? I mean, come on.
It's dodged by another name.
Yeah, right.
But let's start marching.
Well, let's assume that we should listen to what the big mushroom man told us.
300%.
And
he told me that we
should employ tactics. Now, I think I should charge straight in there and kill everything.
Evil. Technically,
stop everything up.
Bad tactics are tactics.
Exactly. So, I'm going to need some input from the rest of you about what you think we should do beyond me going in there and slaughtering
him. I think that's a grand idea. I'll stand back and I'll hold my bow.
What if you charged in, but it wasn't you? It was something that looked like you.
Where are we going to get another?
Well, who's going to slaughter?
Ugly, useless guy around here.
Very few things look as good as I do. I don't think we have enough time.
Does anyone have a piece of fleece? Oh, like I have a piece of fleece.
Oh my god, he's got his components with him. Is that real fleece?
I don't know.
At least lie to me.
So I create, using a silent image, the spitting image of my man on a horse.
That's awesome. Why, if you guys are walking?
He's not actually spitting.
I would never spit like that.
How long did Major Image last?
It lasts up to 10 minutes. It's a concentration, so I get up to 10 minutes.
Very cool. Okay, so as you guys are walking up the path, and you gather it's probably been like 500 meters-ish, you see the path that you're on kind of splits into two. One goes up and one goes down.
We hear anything?
Roll perception!
Thirty-six.
17.
Follow. Always.
18. Yeah. Okay. You two here.
Is that a goat I hear?
What?
Don't bring up goats.
Somebody sounded like it had more than two horns.
can I ask you a question really quick? Did it have a lisp?
It didn't use any S sound. It sounded like it was deliberately trying to avoid making the S sound. Like it was embarrassed of what it would sound like if it made it.
Now, Ewain,
was it being...
Ewain, you know these parts fairly well, and you know that down... yeah, these are your hunting grounds. You hunt this all the time. This is about where you think the watering hole that you were going to find is. Okay. And there should be some, like, clearings down that way, and there's an overlook that you are eventually going to try to use to spot the watering hole, and that's probably what that path is going to be.
So I'm looking for the high ground.
Maybe. Yeah. Whatever your tactics are.
Yeah, man. Archers up high. Let's go.
I'll take the low road.
I hunt these grounds quite often. I think we should take the high ground. There's a clearing up there. Hopefully we can see a watering hole.
I'm with you, Doc Wyatt.
Well, you'll have to come with me.
I have to walk within 60 feet of my image. So does the high road allow for that?
If you're sending... Are you sending the image down the low road?
Yes. Or do I have to follow it?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes.
I drew the map today. Like there is easy access.
Yeah.
Can I go from up to down?
I will say, the map is in my head at this point, so yes, it's fine. Yes.
Okay.
So you can go high and send the image.
All right, I'm concentrating.
Yeah, you gotta kind of, like, keep watch through the trees, though, and kind of, like, see.
Yeah.
So you guys see before you four robed figures, four goblins, a hobgoblin, two githzerai, and a sweet four-horned goat in the center of a six-pointed star that is glowing faintly, tied down to four stakes. Everybody seems to be paying very close attention to the circle. Does anybody speak Abyssal?
Yes.
You do?
I believe I do. No, Undercommon, sorry.
Tiefling. Tiefling.
Oh, got you. So you do?
I speak Tiefling. Dwarf, Tiefling, and Common.
Yeah, so that is, wait, Tiefling speak Infernal, right?
I think they have it.
I'm watching you. Wait, so there's a fiendish language and there's an aberration language, right? And the language of fiends is what tieflings speak. And the language of aberration.
Yes.
They speak infernal. Okay. So nobody understands. You guys hear this.
We get the gist of it without understanding the
example of Egyptian. Yeah.
If any of you kill that goat, I kill you. Understood.
And intercutting the ooh, God.
Oh, God. She has a list. Do you hear him? Do you hear
it? We need, I'm a goat.
There is a slight, there is a slight lisp.
Well, I'm following my phantom steed of myself.
So I guess that would be my action to move the steed, right?
So I'll give you kind of a way.
You're gonna run the steed in?
Fuck yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Wait, not yet. So we can get surprise attacks before. They don't know we're here yet.
Well, they don't know we're up here. If they come charging in.
That's true.
Yeah. That's true, yeah.
We have the high ground, so.
We'll still probably
get surprised. Say, everybody roll a stealth check. And this is how we're going to determine that. It's okay, this is a group roll.
It's fine. It's not an attack roll. Oh, no, I'm a half anyway. So I get to re-roll that.
Yes. Oh, that was the one?
That's my first lucky.
Hey! Hey! It pays to be a halfling.
Really glad you didn't fuck
that. Oh, it definitely pays.
Okay.
Doesn't pay to be a human.
No, it rarely does.
I got a zap one, so I'm at a three. Oh boy, okay. That counts as two failures.
13.
11.
Okay.
13.
Okay.
24.
Okay.
Damn.
Unsurprisingly, the guy in half plate, natural two.
Okay. So we're not going to get a surprise round. As people can start becoming aware that there are people around. They haven't necessarily spotted you, but they're not gonna take a bunch of shots right before we enter initiative. So, everybody roll for initiative!
Yay! Oh, now you fuckers roll around.
I still didn't. Well, you were gonna get another d20.
Pencils and... Okay. Who got a 20 to 25?
Brian. Abby.
Abby.
Bravy.
Bravy, what'd you get?
I got a 22.
Nice. And who got a 15 to 20? Okay. Oh, boy. 10 to 15. Oh, okay. This is looking better. Okay. What'd you get? 10? Okay. Ewain. And
13.
Okay. Minka and
14.
Oh!
Listen.
Shit. Just
two. We love a good two.
Unmodified.
Two. We love that.
I'm following my phantom steed.
Okay, so first up are the cultists. And these four robed figures that are towards like the back area, you see the mummy ones and the
Back here.
Yeah, so that Gith Zera, that yellow guy, is like a body. He's not one of the cultists. But what they are gonna do is they turn into each other, and they start going oomba ra ga ta ga ba, and a portal of fire opens up just to the side of them.
Oh.
And a massive black horse sheathed in shimmering black flames and smoke appears.
See, this is why I asked you if you
want a nightmare.
Hey! Oh, there it is! Ah, you're fired again!
If you like nightmares, may I recommend Brett's Pony Farm? One of our sponsors for the evening.
Oh, boy.
We don't do anything bad to the ponies.
If you don't want nightmares, call Brooklyn and...
All right.
Okay, and that is all the cultists are doing. They have summoned a nightmare. Avi, you're up.
All right, I am going to move... take my action to move the silent image at its speed, which I believe I can do. Make it look like he's charging. But down and to his left.
Okay, cool. So, attention.
Make it play like he's going for the nightmare.
Very cool. Okay.
Force battle.
You doing anything else on your turn?
I am going to move, how easy is it to get down?
Okay. So, it is a 40-foot drop to the ground, okay, from this ledge. You could, with acrobatics or athletics, jump to the tree line, which is directly next to you, and climb down.
Yes.
Okay, give me a either athletics or acrobatics, whichever is better.
22.
Oh, fuck yeah! Look at you, little lemur. So yeah, you jump into the branches of the trees, and you find your footing and start to climb down. But that's going to be your whole movement to get down to the ground.
And that's all I got. I'm not going to for a bonus action. I'm going to do bardic inspiration on my girl here.
Nice. Nice.
You're like, hey, don't fuck it up.
I wipe a tear.
That's awesome.
Thanks, Avi.
That's so motivational. Okay, next up is the Herb Gerblin. Herb Gerblin is not liking any of this, so he's going to pull his short bow out, and he's going to take a shot at the knight riding a horse running through their... ceremony. And he is going to...
Is that this guy?
So, alright, so physical interaction one with this.
I would say an arrow passing through it would let him know that it's an illusion.
Yes, I would agree with that.
Because of the action economy.
But does it have an AC is the question.
It does not. Any physical interaction whatsoever reveals it to be an illusion for the person that interacts with it.
I see. Okay.
Maybe not for the...
What's your AC on that horse? What would it be realistically?
15.
Then he misses. And he has missed the horse, and he's mad.
And is that this guy?
Yeah. No, the hobgoblin is... No, the guy with the choppy sword right... Oh, next to that one? That's hobgoblin. Yep.
Keep pointing, you'll find him eventually.
Hobgoblins are like big red skinned goblins.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
The green goblins suck, don't
forget. That's true. Hobgoblin. Wait, no, hobgoblin wasn't the green goblin's son.
Yes, it is.
No.
In the Sam Raimi ones, it is.
Oh, ew. Hobgoblin is it's another dude, right?
Yeah. I think there's been like three of them.
Yeah, there's been a bunch of them. And he like teams up with Jackal and they fight Spider Man and stuff. Yeah. Yeah, good times. Anyway.
Marvel, don't sue us!
Marvel, sponsor us!
Oh, boy. Wouldn't that be great? Just Marvel Studios. Next week, we'll have Liam Hemsworth.
A bunch of mini-mates scattered around the
world. Well, I know what shirt I'm wearing next.
I love it. Ewain.
Oh.
You're up.
Yeah, I'll draw my bow and my longbow, and I will take a shot at Cultist here.
Okay.
Against AC.
Oh, that's definitely gonna hit him. Roll up your damage.
Oh boy.
Ooh.
Ah! I got 10.
Oh, that's smart. He's still up. Doesn't look super perturbed by that arrow. In fact, you see that arrow like stick into his shoulder, and he just pulls it out and snaps it in one hand and drops it to the ground and starts looking around for where it came from.
Wait, quick question. Do we have advantage right now since we're high up?
I would say you have partial cover.
Okay.
But not necessarily advantage. Because they're all still moving around in combat and stuff.
Makes sense.
Are you doing anything else with your turn, Ewain?
No, I'm all set.
Okay, it's this guy's turn then. And he sees this horse running by, and he's gonna... take a big swing at you.
That's a horse.
And it's gonna whip right through, and he will have become aware that it is an illusion. That brings us to Roscoe.
So I'm going to hide as a bonus action to start with. So I'm gonna...
Very cool.
Gonna hide behind Avi. Oh, you jump down.
But
I'll hide behind longbow up here.
Mm-hmm.
Be like, oh, it's a pretty long bow you got there.
I get that a lot.
Pull up a short bow. And first I'll hide.
Okay.
26.
You feel like you're pretty well hidden.
Yeah. And then I'm gonna take a shot at... Of the four cultists that summoned the nightmare, does it seem like one of them is like the high priest?
They're all wearing the same robes, despite the miniatures.
Dinguses. All right, well, this one, I guess.
Okay.
I'm gonna shoot at him.
Take your shot. With advantage.
Nat 20!
Oh my god!
So I won't roll twice. I'll just take that.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that will do it. And roll... So double damage plus double sneak attack damage.
So 11 damage plus sneak attack. So... 15 total.
Nice. Not a bad round. Okay, yeah, he takes that arrow and, like, falls to the ground. He's still moving, but he's down and like, wriggling, and the other cultists are like, oh, no!
Why are these cultists Italian?
Oh, no! Mamma mia!
I'm summoning here!
Oh, my God. Pasta, spoiled belly. Okay.
All right, that's me.
Yeah, that's your turn. Okay, Minka, you are up.
All right, I would like to take the little piece of leather that ties my braid together and wrap it around my little mimic friend.
Okay.
And I would like to cast Mage Armor on
myself. Nice. Hell yeah. Now you're tough. What is that? That gives you an extra AC?
That is AC becomes 13 plus Dex.
Nice. Right, because you can't wear armor, or you don't.
I can't, so 15.
Nice, very,
yes.
Very.
And it lasts good. For 8 hours.
Yeah, that's true. So this as you do this like shimmering, translucent, like badass armor forms around you, and it is a sight to behold.
You should see a cleric if that lasts more than 4 hours.
And is that your turn, Minka? Anything else?
We established it's not that easy to get down from said...
You'd have to make a successful acrobatics or athletics check to get down through the trees.
You got a plus 2.
I do.
It's not a crazy DC because the tree line is, like, literally right there. You could, like, jump into the trees.
Okay. But I am very small.
You are very small. SMOL.
And if I fall 40 feet, what happens to me?
Well, then you would take 1d6 per 10 feet
yeah.
Falling damage.
Yeah. So it's the potential to be a lot.
Well, I mean, the trees are there to catch the fall.
So. I mean, there may be 4 points.
Jurassic Park style, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I can tell you, like, metagaming, I'm not going to kill your character from jumping, like, from trying to do something cool. I set this encounter up knowing it would offer some different tactical advantages.
Right, that's exactly most of her actions have been killing you.
She's like, all right.
No idea what you're talking about.
Minka in between, yeah, dying tonight. yeah, can I try and get down from, like, into the trees and stuff?
I forgot how to drink it. Yeah, you can. Yeah, I will let you take your movement and make that
right.
Check.
And it's Dex, right?
Yeah. Well, acrobatics or athletics, whatever you're better at.
She's got it.
18.
Oh, yeah! So, like,
yes!
Yeah. So you, like, kind of tumble into the trees, and you find, like, oh, shit, branches. So it's like a ladder. Oh, okay. We're fine. and you get yourself down, and you are currently at the base of the trees in difficult terrain.
Great.
And that, I think, is it for you?
Yeah.
Okay. And so it's Gerblin's turn. I think it's Gerblin's turn. Yeah, it's Gerblin's turn. Okay. Oh, boy. What are we doing here? Gerblins are gonna start running after this guy. Yeah. They're all like, oh, look, a person! They're all gonna start going after the image. Two of them are gonna take a swing at it. And they're both gonna realize that it is an illusion. And then they're gonna start going, like, in their little gerblin, tongue, they're gonna be like, like, pointing at it, like, you know, like gerblins do.
Yeah.
Which, like, translates to
not a horse. Exactly.
Not a
horse. Sir Reginald at the rear.
Really not a horse. I'm 30. So they're 5 feet per square, I'm assuming.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I mean, I can
get close.
I can get close, but I can't attack.
You could double move. You can only take the dash action.
Yep.
Instead of an attack.
Yeah. No,
leave you vulnerable for a round, but.
Or you can take the dodge action.
Or ready in action. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Well, you can't ready in action. Well, wait, yeah, you can. Yeah. You can totally ready in action.
Well, I'm gonna do my 30 and shield up. And
that look good for you?
Yeah. And say, let's see how you do against the real thing.
Nice.
Gobbos.
Oh, I love it.
Fuck a gobbo, to be honest. Where's your dick at, Gabo?
Oh boy, that brings us to the nightmare's turn.
At least I've moved into his brain.
The nightmare. Oh boy, yeah. The nightmare is gonna see you enter the fray and right up to you, and it is going to try to trample you with its big fiery. No. it is, well, I mean, you could try.
I'm gonna get fired.
So it takes its big, massive, fiery hooves and tries to stomp on you with them.
1-7.
I don't think a natural one's gonna do it, though. So it's gonna miss its...
It trips.
...only attack of the turn. And that nightmare is, like, big and imposing and scary, and no, no, no!
And that's what you do? You just kind of... ready then.
It's fair. So, the cultists, one of them holds their hand over the fallen cultist, and a green glow kind of emanates from their palm, and you see the other cultist, like, start to stand up and, like, dust himself off, and then the other two start going, Oonga, runga, bunga, donga. And, who could see this? Minka and... Why doesn't everybody make a perception check?
Haha. 12.
Okay.
23.
Okay.
21. 17.
I'm still working on it. I'm sorry. I'm not used
to
this app.
Oh, you're fine.
All right. So I'm at a 17.
Okay. So you all notice that as they start chanting, one of the four stakes that holds Petunia down into that little pit with the six-pointed star, one of the stakes lights up with a little glowing rune on it.
How many stakes are holding?
Four. And one of them is glowing. Avi, you're up.
What part of the star is the stake that's glowing?
Is it which stake is glowing?
It would be the one closest to Caelan.
This one in the corner?
Yep.
Cool.
Here,
I got it.
I got Expo markers right here, too. If you want to draw a little circle around it.
This guy, right?
Yep. You can tell he's an administrator. One-handed, uncapping these pens, baby.
All right, I'm going to move in that direction. I'm going to take my 30 and walk up to this motherfucker. Well, I'm sheathing my rapier.
Okay, yeah.
As a free action, I'm dropping concentration.
On the illusion? Okay, the illusion. So that goes away?
Yep. And I'm gonna hit this motherfucker with my rapier.
I love it.
14 plus 5, so 19 to hit.
Which one are you attacking?
This guy right next to the nightmare.
The Bob Goblin.
Yeah, 19, that'll hit. Roll right. Damage.
7-10 damage total.
Hey, what do you say?
Wow. That is pretty solid.
Actually, I'm gonna use some of my martial prowess, and he's going to swing at me, and I'm gonna riposte.
Oh yeah, I love that.
And as I riposte, I'll say, "Hey, nice try, Dick." I'm gonna hit him with the false edge with an upward cut.
Oh, I like that. I like that. You're getting very specific on this, and I like it. And anything else on your turn?
As a free action, I will give Bardic Inspiration to my dude.
Nice. Ooh. What do you say to give him that inspiration?
Hey, do the same thing. Cutting them works.
Fuck, that's so good. Okay, that brings us to the Herb Gerblin.
Wait, how's he doing? Is he?
He's hurting. I mean, like, I'm not going to really answer that question. That's fine. But on a scale from 1 to 11, you would say, you know, he's not doing great.
1 to 11, great.
And he is going to come running. Oh, yeah. He's coming up right behind you.
With advantage.
Yeah.
That sounds fine.
Do we do flanking rolls? Are we doing flanking rolls?
Flanking works for specific features like pack tactics or sneak attack.
Yeah.
But typically, no, I do not apply flanking rules. That's a Pathfinder thing. Sorry, internet.
One guy is so angry at home right
now. Yeah, I know. He's like, why are you not flanking?
He's just X out of the podcast now.
Yeah. We lost a viewer forever. Forever and ever and ever. Who just went to his... Oh, it's Herb Gerblin making an attack.
Funny.
Oh, right. Yeah. Oh, my... Does a 15 hit?
It does not, you motherfucker.
All right, then he's going to take
I easily switch my buckler back behind me, like...
Yeah. He's going to take a second swing at you then. Oh, boy. I'm thinking of 21 hits.
Fuck you, yeah.
So you are going to take 7 damage. Oh, sorry. You are going to take 6 damage plus 7 damage because he's flanking you. So 13 damage total.
That's more than half.
Oh, that's fine. Oh, so your glasses fall off.
Yeah, my glasses fall off, I guess.
Yeah, he kind of like, he misses on the first one.
14? 13.
So he misses on the first swing. You kind of duck out of the way, and as you're like, haha, fuck you, dude. He like takes the butt of the sword and whacks you in the face, like hits you in the temple, and the glasses just go flying off.
Oh, goddamn.
And it hurt. And that is going to bring us to Ewain.
All right, Ewain is going to set up a nice long shot here. I'm going to aim for the rune glowing stake. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
That is going to be a 13.
Not going to do it.
Now on my turn.
It's a little steak.
Very little steak.
Okay. That brings us to... Oh, boy. That brings us to... This guy. He's going to come up right to you there, Sir Reginald. And he is going to... He kind of, like, looks at you, and he sizes you up, and he puts his knives away, and he just strikes at you with his fist. And that is going to be... A 22 to hit.
Yeah.
So you are gonna take 4 damage and 4 psychic damage, as he kind of gets like right into your helmet and like pops you right in that fleshy part of your face, and you see this like purple energy crackle out of his knuckles and like right into your eyes, and your head is hurting. You get a migraine now. And that's going to be his turn.
Thank you, Dave.
I believe that's my
turn. Yeah, that's pretty good. That brings us to Roscoe.
Can I be hidden from a stake in the ground?
Hidden from a stake in the ground. Are you asking if you have advantage on...
Extra time to aim, not for math.
Yeah. Because, I think because the... idea of sneak attack is you have the time to like line up your shot and you're not being seen by anybody, so you're under less pressure. I think I will allow advantage. All right, yeah.
I'm gonna shoot at that glowing stick.
Okay. Yeah.
12.
That's not gonna do it.
Yeah, it's not gonna.
Not gonna do it.
Sorry.
Shooting out! Fucking shooting these cams! She said we're supposed to kill the goat, right? That's what they
want. I'm pretty certain.
Yeah.
That's
if we kill it, they can't sacrifice it.
True story.
Fuck, that's dark.
Shit!
monsters! Oh boy.
I'm done.
Okay. Alright, so that's gonna bring us to Minka!
I would like to cast Acid Splash on this asshole right here.
Okay, and I'm
probably running a
puncher. I'm this asshole right there.
At this point, I'm trusting you with the range of your spells because they're all
feet.
Ungodly. Yeah. Okay.
Everything is in range.
Everything's in range. You're fine.
Except my poison spray, which is only 10 feet.
Right.
Target must succeed a dex saving throw.
Okay. That's an 8.
Does that succeed?
Your DC should be 10 plus your casting modifier. So your casting modifier
is
would be
5.
Okay, so 15. So 8 does not. Okay.
You take 4 acid damage.
That hobgoblin is dead.
Yay! Nice.
Oh, I turn around and look up at you and I go, "That's one."
Nice. Anything else with your turn, Minka?
Nope.
Okay. Gerblin time. It's Gerblin time. Okay.
Now Marvel really guys are gonna do us.
I know. All right, so this guy's just gonna take a swing at Avi. Ooh. Yes. This little Gerblin's gonna come up behind Sir Wrench. This little gerblin went to market. I'm gonna try to find it. Okay, I guess. Oh, well.
He would have left my threatened area.
Yep. So he provoked an attack of opportunity from you, Avi.
Doesn't hit.
Way to go, 4 eyes.
Nice.
Now 2 eyes.
I have disadvantage, but a 4 on disadvantage is not gonna get better for me.
I mean, yeah, that's true. Okay, so one of them's taking a swing at Avi. One of them taking a swing at Reg. Oh, there's another goblin.
There are 2 on Reginald that are not the nightmare.
2 on Reginald that are not. Yeah, that's a gets 0 eyes, so he's gonna go. He's gonna run up to you. So 2 are taking attacks on Minka, 1's taking attack on Avi, and 1 on Sir Reginald. The 2 on Minka. You said it was a 15?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 1 hit, and that is going to be for 5 damage.
Okay.
And then on Avi, that's a hit. I assume with an 18 on the die, plus 4 to hit, so a 22 to hit.
You'll hit me.
Yeah, okay. And that is going to be for 5 damage, and Sir Reginald, 13 is going to miss.
Avi's down.
Avi drops right next to
him. Oh, Avi's down. Okay. Oh boy, things are heating up there. Okay, that is going to bring us to Sir Reginald then.
Thank you. I would like to return the favor and give that guy who punched me in the mouth a face full of the mace.
Awesome. Take your swing, baby. Take your swing.
That's... That went far away. And that's a 9.
9. 9's not gonna do it.
It's nothing. But as my free action, I would like to inspire someone heroically.
Yes, the new knight feature.
Oh, don't you have a bardic inspiration?
I can use my inspiration. Too late.
Too late on this one. Just because you've already, so I allow inspiration to be used after the die is rolled, but before you know whether it's a success or failure.
That's all right. As my free action heroic inspiration, life is Minka!
Hey.
I don't like that! You get my... Look at me! I'm holding off this whole crowd!
You're unconscious. Oh yes.
That's so inspired.
That can be.
But your glasses aren't broken because you were knocked prone and they were on the ground. So there's that.
Yeah.
You're like shielding them with your body.
Yeah.
No one will trample on these glasses.
Anything else with your turn, Sir Reginald?
He's explaining.
Oh, that was my free act. No, that is the end.
Okay.
He's explaining his gift to me.
It's a damage checker save. I'm going to add it to one.
Oh, very cool.
It's basically a damage checker.
Hmm. That's super cool. Excellent. It is the Nightmare's turn, who is going to try and stomp again on Sir Reginald. Another nat one.
Really?
That's all you do.
I mean, compared to... Ah! Oh,
I'm the scary one.
I'm a scary pony.
I will just put like peanut butter on the horse's gum so it looks like it's talking.
I'll get you a carrot in a minute. I have to fight these guys.
Wow, that sucks. And the cultists, the two other cultists join in this chant. Oonga gumba gandawa, and a second stake glows. Doesn't matter. Just another one of the stakes starts glowing.
Stakes have never been higher.
Hey!
See, my puns are good. He likes my
puns. See, it would be better if, like, if y'all were, like, hanging out with cows in the Mushroom Kingdom, and you fed the cows the mushrooms, and then you could say the steaks had never been higher.
We have to go back there.
Like, move. Okay. What just happened?
You just played Nightmare.
Oh, I just played Nightmare. Oh, right, and the steak starts to glow. Avi, it's your turn. And you are unconscious to make a death saving throw.
DC 10.
Yes.
Just raw dice roll, right?
Just raw.
One failure.
Oh boy.
Okay.
It was a 7.
Yep. Also, do not forget, as per Adventurer League rules, at the beginning of every session, you guys start off with a potion of 2d4 healing.
Would be cool if someone conscious could help.
Yeah. It's going to be a full action to feed somebody else the potion, but it is possible.
Okay.
Oh,
right, we don't have our healer.
Yeah. Your healer's out.
Also, my concentration is broken, so who did I cast Heroism on? Did I?
Oh no, it was on Sir Reginald's. Or not Heroism, that was Bardic Inspiration.
Bardic Inspiration.
Yeah, I didn't cast Heroism.
So you didn't cast Heroism.
Yeah, you're fine.
No. So the inspiration.
My concentration would have been broken anyway when I got knocked out.
We're still inspired.
We're fine.
I'm so inspired.
I am doubly inspired. I'm really incredibly inspired right now.
Hobgoblin's dead, which means it's Ewain's turn.
Alright, Ewain. This is debating on whether or not he wants to take another shot at this. Yeah, I think he's going to take. No, he's gonna take a shot at this goblin right here.
Okay.
Since he's so close.
Take the shot. set right there for you.
That is going to be a 14. 14.
A 14 to hit the goblin?
Yep.
Not gonna do it.
Wow, we got really excited.
It's a fucking AC.
Not gonna do it.
Yeah, I really need to. I'm gonna use this.
Here, take the whole set.
Yeah. Okay, I laid out that set for you. Okay. So that is. Is that the end of your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. So it is the Gizlier Eyes turn, and he is gonna take another pot shot at you. Two more pot shots at you. That's a nat one. Oh boy. And,
you're just
cranking
out the nat
one. Yeah, this one's really putting me through the ringer here.
That's a great one.
17, so this is a hit. So you are going to take another 6 damage, and then another 5 psychic damage.
Sorry.
Not going great for the tanks.
Yes.
This guy's rolling high. oh boy. Okay, so that's gonna be Roscoe's turn.
I'm going to hide again. Or am I still hidden?
You're still hidden. You're fine.
I'm gonna take another shot at the cultist that I first shot, who got healed, or something. He got green glowed.
Yep.
Green glowed.
Yeah, you could probably assume he got healed.
Yeah. 14.
14. Will hit.
Yes.
Roll damage.
Plus 4. sneak 6 damage.
Okay. He's not looking great, he kind of stutters and falters in his chanting for a moment, and you see one of the runes just kind of flicker a little bit, and it goes back to glowing.
Okay.
Anything else on your turn?
Nope.
Okay. Minka.
I am going to cast Acid Splash on both of these guys.
Right.
Because I can choose 2 creatures within range that are within 5 feet of each other. I am assuming they are within 5
they
feet of
are,
each other.
They are within 5 feet of each other. All right. Correct. Very good.
Dex saving throw, my good DM.
Boy, oh boy. Okay. All right. Another nat 1!
Yay!
And a 14, so that's 2 failures. That's 2 failures. So roll your damage.
3.
It's 3 damage?
Yes.
On both of these Gerbies.
They're not giving me any better looking.
They're definitely not, and they're kind of screaming. They're like, bah, rah, 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 rah,
rah, rah, rah. Is the acid melting them a little bit?
Yeah, it's gross. It smells bad, too.
All right. I like gagging.
Even worse than normal gum.
Yeah. And I thought they smelled bad. Well, on the outside.
I'm like gagging on the trees.
Oh.
And reflex splash that you should just do.
That's awesome. Okay, so then it is going to... Anything else on your turn?
Nope.
Okay, it is now the Gerblin's turn, and they're like... so they're
not
going to take...
Oh, no, that's not good.
Okay, so one is a missed.
Okay.
The other's a nat 20.
Oh, fuck.
So you are going to take 10 damage as this goblin just kind of smacks you with his club.
I'm at 1 whole AC, guys.
Oh boy.
Stagger.
Okay. And then we've got how many more goblins we got? We got 1 on Sir Reginald. Gonna take a swing, and that's a swing and a miss. You said it was 18.
Talk to the shield. 17.
17. Oh, 17 hits then.
Talk to the shield.
Oh, shit. So that's another 5 damage for you. Mm. And then who else we got? Any more gerblins? Oh, that one's over by Avi. He doesn't care anymore. He's gonna run back to the cultists.
Give him 30?
30. Okay.
It's about as close as I can get.
Yep, that's good. Yeah, he's gonna hang by the cultists, and he's gonna draw his bow, and he's gonna look around, and he's not gonna see you guys up top. And that is going to be Sir Reginald's turn!
Again, with the same one.
Mace face.
Mace face.
Okay.
Alright. I'm
just gonna use it. Okay.
Yeah, d6. Yeah. And so that's
18. 18 hits.
That's what
we very good! Bardic Inspiration coming in clutch, baby! Roll your damage.
Just do that, it looks really great!
Not bad yet!
Oh, dang!
Four, no proficiency right now, the 1 damage, right? Holding strength.
No, you should get a... Oh, yeah. If you're proficient with... Yeah.
Four, we're going to use that. 9!
9, huh? Okay.
9.
He's still up.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
What a dork.
Yeah. Anything else on your turn?
No. I don't think it's a free action.
Very well. Nightmare is going to try stomping you again.
That doesn't look like a nat one. Three in a row.
But it is. What do you get?
You get the stuffed pony.
That's a 17, baby.
You did 3 in a row. 17.
Okay, so that is going to be 7 bludgeoning damage and 3 fire damage.
I'm sorry, 7 and 3?
7 bludgeoning, 3 fire.
Oh, Reggie goes down.
Oh. This is not going well.
It's a short podcast.
Yeah, I know.
And right. That was Lights Up Day.
So we're playing with us for both weeks.
Bonus action.
Lights out.
What were you going to do?
Stamina Surge, give myself 1d6 plus my con bonus hit points.
Go ahead, do it.
Thanks. Reggie may not go down. We'll see. Well, anything, really. So that's 5 minus 2, 3. I'm still up.
Okay. Awesome. Okay. Good.
For now. For a while.
Not for a whole much longer.
Okay, so the nightmare has taken its turn, and the cultists start going, ooh, up wrong, ooh, cha-cha-cha, I can't stop this, and the goblins is a deep inside of me.
The strangest intro to any pop song we can do.
It really is. David Hasselhoff actually appears from there and descends down to save you. It's a Hasselhoff machina. I'm fired.
You want to do another?
It's another stake is glowing. Oh, and three stakes are glowing!
What is Petunia doing at this?
Petunia's.
No! What else does it go to?
I'm a goat!
Please save me.
Guys. Come on, guys. Guys.
Are there any pools of water rippling?
Get me out of here, guys!
We need the T-Rex.
Oh yeah, minor illusion T-Rex in there.
Thank you, Gina.
Awesome. Avi, it is your turn to make a death saving throw.
Give me that fucking 20.
Get that 20.
20.
16. Okay, that's success. Okay, we're good. Ewain.
All right. I'm gonna shoot at one of the runes again, and I'm just gonna hope and pray.
Okay.
Do the one closest to me.
Okay.
Okay. 17?
17 total?
17 total.
That'll do it.
Yes. All right.
So, and roll your damage.
If it explodes and kills my goat, I'm gonna eat.
Yes. 7.
Okay.
Wait, plus 2, so 9.
Okay, which one were you aiming for?
This guy right here.
You stick right into it, and it splits down the center, but it is still glowing. It's just flickering.
Oh. It's fucking stakes. Got it with these fucking stakes on this fucking gun.
Oh, fuck. Anything else on your turn?
It was a cheap one, sorry.
Oh, yeah, sorry, no, I'm good.
Okay. That means it is the Githzerai's turn. He's gonna take a couple of pot shots at Reggie.
What did you say?
Githzerai.
Okay.
Yeah?
The yellow guy?
No, yeah.
Fine.
Yes. It's a race. Closest.
I have a feeling if this goat is sacrificed, we're not gonna like the outcome.
That is two misses on you. He just whips.
Try with a weapon. That's Sally Jean's throw. Come on.
And then it is going to be Roscoe's turn.
I'm going to take a shot at the cultist I've been pinging away at here. See if we can finish him off for realsies. Mm-hmm. Just in case. 18.
18 on that cultist?
Yeah.
Roll for damage.
7 total.
7 total damage. He goes,
yes.
And
sorry to ruin your day.
Fuck.
That's your first one.
That's one pink eye.
Pink eye. Fuck, that's great. Oh god, Roscoe's nicknames are so good. Okay. Anything else on your turn there, Roscoe?
Nope.
Cool. Minka, you are up.
All right. What do I want to do? Great, I'm kind of thinking I'm gonna blast him again. I'm gonna do that again.
Yeah, that's a cantrip?
Yes, sir.
Alright.
Yes, it is.
Do your dex saving throws?
Yes.
That is a 21 and an 18.
Oh, damn, alright.
Yike. Now I roll well.
Yep.
Anything else on your turn?
Can I run away from them?
You can, but you would provoke an attack of opportunity by doing so.
Do alright, then now I'm going to stay where I am.
Okay.
Can't disengage 5 feet as your move?
As an action, you can disengage.
Ah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Rough. 5-foot step is a Pathfinder thing.
That's an action they can re-engage.
I think it was a 4th edition thing, too.
Oh, yeah, it was a 4th edition thing, too, wasn't it? I haven't played 4E in years. Oh,
nobody
God.
Has.
That was my first
reason
for that. Oh, God. Four
I love it,
not good.
And then another day we'll talk about it.
Yeah. Anyway.
But I'm not
the combat
dying.
Would be a lot more excruciating if we were playing 4A right
oh
now.
Oh, my God. Or if we were playing Pathfinder 1st edition, it would just be like a long-form calculus equation. Anybody's turn. Excellent. It is the Gerblin's turn. Okay.
Yeah.
The Gerblins
oh,
are
right.
Up.
I had one AC. I should have drank a potion or something.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, Mika's going down.
Certainly possible. That's
it, more importantly, Petunia's going down.
If you
down.
Hit me at all, I go down. I have one HP.
Minka's unconscious.
Minka is down.
Oh, Jesus.
Start rolling. Okay, will you stop shooting at the stake? I do not. Hello!
Yeah. And then we go
literally
tactics, Reggie. Tactics.
Literally fish in a barrel, folks.
Gerblin misses you, Sir Reginald.
Yes, of course it is.
And it is now your turn.
Okay. Final. One more time. Mace to face. I gotta get rid of that guy. And that's plenty. 20.
It's plenty.
20. Yeah, that'll do it.
And 6 points of damage.
Still up.
Oh, God.
Most durable goblins I've ever seen.
He's not,
yeah,
a
not a goblin.
He's a Gitzerai.
He's a Gitzerai. Not that I know what that means.
What he said. Some type of crazy
cult. I didn't mean to be insensitive.
He threw away his knives and then started punching me.
They're right? Not a super uncommon race. Gitzerai and Githyanki are typically like monks or disciples of a certain like religious order. And they are very skilled and dexterous, very similar to like dark elves.
And they don't like using weapons.
I mean, this one doesn't. Yeah, he's still up. And now, oh boy. So the nightmare is gonna try one last time to stomp you. It's 16.
Yay!
16 does not.
Yeah, I know. I'm really trying to put him down. This is not working. And the cultists, seeing their fallen cult member, they start frantically chanting, Ooga, ra, ba, ooga, na, ga. And they vanish.
Ooh.
With the nightmare.
Oh, I thought you were going to say the goat.
Yeah. What about this?
Oh, God. I don't think we're going to like what happens to the goat.
He goes with them.
Okay. Oh, no.
And this goblin's like, what the fuck?
oh, no.
The blue glowing runes.
Don't kill my goat.
Don't summon something. Please don't summon something.
Fade away.
Yeah. That would be great.
Petunia!
and Petunia is still in the bottom of this pit, just...
Got him. Yeah, you're fine. Goodbye. Stuff's down here. Oh, this is so good.
Okay. Now that brings us to Avi. I'm going to need you to make a death saving throw, my friend.
Yeah, another failure.
Oh, God.
Fuck me. Okay. Ewain, you are up.
There's no way I can get to you. I'm sorry, buddy.
That's all right.
I guess I'll just attack one of these goblins right here.
Can you get to me?
Oh, yeah, you're down too. Shit.
Oh, wait. Does it take an entire action to get down?
Yeah, and it takes an entire action
to... An entire action to feed, yeah.
...to the potion, so the best I can do is get these goblins off your back, I think.
Probably.
Mm-hmm. Well, I also don't want you to go down, so maybe I should.
If you give him some support, I can try and take care of
him. Come on, hop over here. I don't have line of sight on this.
You're 30 feet higher.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
And I'm in plate now.
Yeah, I'll go for this guy.
Half plate,
I'll go for
the
top.
Okay.
The cold.
Go for
him.
Yeah, the sexy
Yeah.
The
best.
Right over here.
Rapping.
Oh, yeah. I got a 17.
That's gonna hit.
It's gonna hit. Nice. 78. That's gonna be a 7 points of damage.
Okay. He's still up.
That's tough.
He's very tough, and it is now his turn, and he's going to take another couple of pot shots at you.
Vin Diesel.
Jesus Christ. An 8 and a 2. Okay.
He's sturdy.
Very sturdy. Very fast.
Not good at aiming.
Apparently not the greatest at aiming. Yeah. Roscoe.
All right. Yeah. So, okay. How does getting down from this cliff work exactly?
Athletics or acrobatics.
And then you can still do actions and everything afterwards?
I'll let you use your entire movement to get to the base.
30 feet.
It's like a 40-foot drop, but if you jump down onto the tree and
yeah,
and scurry right.
down. I'm going to sling my bow
yeah.
over my back and pull my two daggers out and fucking leap for it.
Oh, fuck yeah. Give me athletics or acrobatics, whichever is better.
21.
Nice.
Yo, yeah, you get down there and like those cool like pirate movies where the dude jumps on the sail and...
Yeah.
Like, yeah, you straight up just zip down the tree.
Sweet, cool.
So with a dagger in each hand, I'm going to do some two-weapon fighting here.
Oh, sorry.
And try and...
You're good.
So I'll try and stab this guy in the gut with my first dagger.
Okay.
18.
That is going to hit. Roll for damage.
Pull those guts out.
5.
Dead.
Sweet.
It smells awful, though, I'm sure.
And then,
got him.
Do the same thing on the second one.
Great, go for it.
19.
That's a hit. Roll for damage.
This one doesn't get the damage. So that's just one damage.
Okay, he's still up. Okay, anything else? You're out of moves, aren't you?
I am. That's one more, Dinkus.
I know, I got.
Don't.
You're unconscious.
Well, I'll remind her when she wakes up.
It is your turn to make a death saving throw.
14.
That's a success.
Yay.
Okay. Gerblin time. All right, so this guy's going to take a swing at you, Roscoe, with a 17 to hit.
That hits.
Okay. You're going to take 5 damage.
Oh, this is why I stay on the cliffs, people.
This other Gerblin's going to take a swing at Sir Reginald. 16 to hit's not going to do it.
Ka-ching.
Do I have any Gerblins left? That one
yeah,
last
this guy?
He
drew his bow last turn.
Yes, he's going to take a shot at... Actually... Oh, yeah. He's going to take a shot at you, Ewain. All
right.
And he's gonna miss.
Sounds like you need better dice.
Yeah, now available next time.
That's true. I need more dice than all of the dice that I have.
Dice are fine.
Two of us.
Dice not coming up your way. This session is brought to you by Gamblers Anonymous.
Fuck. Oh, that's good. That's good. Okay. That was all the Gerblins. Sir Reginald.
Oh. I mean, fucking just one more time.
Okay.
Cultist?
The cultist. Oof. 20. No, I'm that. 20.
A nat 20?
No.
Oh, a dirty 20. Oh. Scare me for a second.
And 5 points.
He's still up.
He's still kicking. He is very bloody, and he's like, bleh. But he's still technically up. You've bashed him in the face a few times with this mace, and he is very sturdy. And that means it is... Oh god, the nightmare's gone, the cultists are gone. The...
Last possible death save.
Here we go. Roll big, roll big.
Oh,
so man.
Don't get.
We still got one more to go. Shit. Okay.
God.
Ewain, I got king.
Ewain, it is your turn.
I'll take a shot at that. Oh, it seems like you have a personal thing with this cultist. So I'll leave the cultist to you.
I mean, no, all right. Whatever you, the goblins can do.
I'll go down. I'll take a shot at this goblin. I barely know these people. I'm not going to step down there and risk my life.
So fair.
They saved you from a fucking prison.
That's true.
Almost fun.
So I got a 19.
Not me, but...
19 on...
This goblin.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, roll a hit.
6 points of damage.
Okay.
Still up.
It's still up.
I don't think we've done much to this one, so...
Yeah. I think that was the first time that one was hit.
Rough.
Yes.
There's been
quite a bit kind going on.
My Little Pony and...
Yeah. I'll forgive you.
And, cultist over here that you got a personal vendetta with.
He punched it.
I get it.
I mean...
Makes sense.
Okay. Who's went? What was, Ewain? Cultist turn. Ewain? Whatever. However it is. Miss and...
Okay. I'm just gonna go to Roscoe.
I need stabilizing.
Yeah.
I'm going to use my bonus action to disengage.
Nice.
On this guy.
Clever.
And scooch around and through him over here to Roscoe. Nice. Or to Avi.
Mm-hmm.
And try and do a medicine check to stabilize him.
Oh, yeah, sure.
And I fail.
Ooh.
I just kind of pat him on the head and I'm like, hey.
Buddy, I think you're
get
bleeding.
Avi. Oh, I thought you were putting glasses on. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to poke you.
Get a cork and stick it in the wound.
Take his glasses and dust them off. And try.
Pressure, it's just pressure. It's not hard.
But that's me.
Okay. Mink, death saving throw, please.
14 again?
Yes.
All right.
Success. 2-0, baby. Okay. Garblins. What are they gonna do? That guy's gonna turn around and he's gonna attack Roscoe.
This guy?
Yep. Thank you.
You have a potion you could have.
And that one's gonna take another swing at Reggie. Roscoe, does a 15 hit your AC, bud?
Yes, it does.
That is going to be 5 points of damage.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That cliff is looking better and better.
That's why I say it up here.
Sorry for distracting.
Okay. And it was a myth on Sir Reginald. Are there only 2 Gremlins left?
Yeah.
Damn.
Oh, wait, no, there's this guy still over here.
Oh, right. That guy's going to take a shot with his bow again at Ewain and miss again. Switching dice.
Don't.
Dice jail.
Don't.
Dice jail.
Going into dice jail. Okay. And now it is Sir Reginald's turn.
Reggie.
Take one this cultist down. More time. I mean, it didn't. I don't.
It's a skew. Again.
It's a skew. It's a skew, I tell you. And that's a 16.
Total?
Total.
Not gonna do it.
Oh, God.
Not gonna.
As a free action, I'm gonna have a stamina surge again.
Mm.
5 points back.
Sick. That's super cool. What a great feature.
And I'm out of that for the day.
I'm not a lot.
That's okay, they're almost done. We got this.
Yeah. Everything's fine, right?
50-50. More than half our party's down, but you know.
Everything's fine.
Avi?
Woo!
I assume that cheering was for a success and not a failure.
I
got a 16. So that's my third success.
So you are unconscious, but you are stabilized.
Woo! Okay. Ow!
Yep.
I holler in my sleep sometimes.
He has night terrors. Avi suffers from night terrors. Ewain, it is your turn.
I'll take a shot at the goblin again.
Okay.
Didn't take much.
Go for it.
Oof, not gonna make it.
Okay.
7 total?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Hey,
anything else?
Hey, nope. Watch it with the arrows.
Okay, this guy is gonna take 2 more swings. That's Sir Reginald. One is a 7, the other is a 17, baby!
Oh.
He's way too excited.
All right.
Way too expensive.
He's not good at getting rolls recently. So
no, I'm very excited about it. 8 points of bludgeoning damage, but no psychic damage this time.
Reggie is unconscious.
Oh my god!
Wait, how do I wake up?
Stagger.
He needs some time, or somebody needs to wake you up.
Leave it to the archers.
Yeah. Okay, so. Oh boy.
Alright, next time you take all the goblins, I'll attack the stakes. And they know.
Roscoe, you are up.
I am. I'm just gonna try and finish this guy off with one of my daggers here.
Okay, roll it.
16.
That's gonna do it. Roll for damage.
4 plus, there's an unincapacitated out. So 8 damage total.
Dead.
Yes.
Woo!
Alright, and there were 3.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
there's still 3?
Yeah, but this guy's almost gone.
So I know that drinking a potion yourself is...
a free action.
An action. Oh, what about giving it to somebody else?
That 10 action.
Oh, yeah. Then, I'm not gonna do anything.
Okay. Minka, death saving throw, please.
Come on.
Come on, one more.
Nice.
10?
10.
That's it.
Made it.
Yay. Where's my cheering?
No! You had 2 successes. So.
Yeah.
It wasn't as much of a nail, but
Yeah, you had a full count going there.
That was
pretty funny. Minka, you are unconscious and stable.
Yay!
Me too.
Gerblin time. Okay. We got one with a bow. Okay, so the other Gerblin is going to pull out his bow, and they're both going to take shots at the archer up top. Does an 18 hit your armor class?
It does.
Okay, so one of those is going to hit, and it's going to be 5 piercing damage.
Alright, I've never used this before. Do I just type in?
Yeah, I think you can just like... I also have your HP tracked here.
Cool. I'm just going to let you do it then.
Perfect. Yes, because before like 5:30, I was going to be playing Ewain as an NPC. But thank you for being here, Devin.
Pinch hitter.
Awesome. Okay, so that
I haven't done much,
one.
But... I got the snake.
You shot the snake, yeah.
You got the snake.
I ran down and died.
Nice. You know, anyone can do that, though.
I will need a death saving throw from you, my friend.
I'm not.
Didn't do you much. Stable?
I'm stable.
Wait, how are you stable?
I'm at 0, and it was concussive. I'm not at negative. I'm at 0.
Okay.
I said I fall down, not I expire.
That's pretty wild. Okay. Yeah. Is that rules as written?
No. Nope.
That's bird law.
Is bird law?
0.
So, rules is written when you fall to 0.
In order to be bleeding.
No, well, no. So when you fall to 0, you drop to unconscious and begin death saving throws. Yeah. If the blow that puts you down exceeds your negative value of hit points. So say you have 20 hit points. If it takes you to -20, then you're dead. But whenever you fall to 0 hit points, you begin making death saving throws. Unconscious.
You're just kind of napping right now. Thinking about getting up again.
I mean, I can. You want me to death
save? Yeah, just make a death save.
There's a light at the end of the tunnel.
You got it. I mean, that's a 19.
That's a pass. All right, that's one.
So you have to do 2 more.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, or one of us can passing it.
Kick you in the ribs until you wake up, basically.
I just imagine that scene, like, you guys hitting each other in the face until one of you drops.
Yeah, I love that. Okay, now it is going to be Avi, you are unconscious.
So that's I can do nothing, or can I roll to...
Roll me a... I mean, typically you're down for the rest of the fight.
Yeah, until...
But why don't you roll me a d20, just roll me a flat d20.
10.
Nah, you're still down.
Okay.
Ewain, you are up.
I'm gonna stay up here.
because it's worked out pretty well for me so far.
Fair enough.
All right, I'm going to take a shot at... I got your back, buddy. I'm going to take a shot and try to finish off this cultist. Right in the head. And that's 15 plus 4, so I got a 19.
That's going to hit.
Nice.
Roll your damage.
Do I really need to?
I totally saw them.
That's going to be a 6. What's it look like? Where do you hit him? What does it look like? Oh, I'm aiming right between the eyes. I want that thing to just... And then I want him to fly back and hit the back of his head on what I assume is a rock here.
Yep, yep.
And I want, like, the back of his head to just open up, like, bloody.
Oh, yeah, straight up. That's exactly what happened. Dude's dead as fuck! Woo!
I totally saw him in the mouth.
Awesome.
I mean, he had one hit point.
What's remaining of his head, at least?
Yeah. Bloodiness. Just the two gerblins left.
We run away. That's
Petunia. I'm down here, guys. We're taking long enough.
Great. So he's dead, and so it can't be his turn. Roscoe, you're up.
So I'm going to kind of roll Avi onto its side and try and crouch and hide behind him.
Very cool. Roll that stealth check.
I'm administering
22.
You feel like you are pretty well hidden.
All right. He's feeling 22.
Hey.
At this archer over here. Show him what's up. 16 plus 21 to hit.
Yeah, that's definitely going to hit.
So that is 8 damage plus sneak attack, 12 damage total.
Yeah, it's dead.
Yes,
dead.
No.
Nice!
Damn, I
gotta
catch up here.
Are you guys still keeping the sword?
Yeah.
I mean, if you can call him. But she had the score, yeah.
It's more than one in the score!
That's amazing.
We're having a lay down.
That's amazing. Okay, anything else on your turn there, Roscoe?
Yeah, I'll take some movement and come over here just so he doesn't try and hit him while he's not there.
Very cool, very cool. Minka, you are unconscious. Roll a flat d20 for me.
Oh. 19.
You are up and you can start to do things next round.
Yay.
Okay.
You are
still prone, but you are conscious now. Okay. You're like, whoa, hey, I'm up, and you have one hit point and you are conscious but prone. Okay.
Great.
Gerblin time. Okay. You just walked right up into its grill, huh? Mm-hmm. So it's gonna drop its bow and pull out its little dagger and take a swing at you and whip.
Ha.
Okay, and...
odd job, I'm very hard to hit because I'm so small.
Yeah. You got that, your hitbox is...
You're bobbing.
Okay, and then the other gerblin is
ain't
going...
No other there ain't no other gerblin.
Yeah. It's dead. That's it, no more gerblins. Okay, guys. Sir Reginald, please make another death saving throw for me.
15.
Yeah!
Successes. Excellent. All right, Avi. Roll a flat d20.
Nope, one.
Okay, you are still unconscious.
You it's actually so take damage from
that. I mean, it's like a feather bed.
I want to finish this gerblin.
You're up.
All right, I'm going to take a shot at this last gerblin here. Ooh, I don't know if I'm going to get that. 12? Not going to do it.
But, Roscoe, you got a gerblin in your face.
Yeah, let's finish him off. I'm going to double dagger him here. One is 10.
Nope.
And the second one is 17.
That's gonna hit. Roll your damage.
6.
Dead as a doornail. Oh, and we are out of initiative.
So tactically, I think that could have gotten better for me personally.
Somebody's gonna need to come and stabilize Sir Reginald real quick.
Are we up?
Yeah. You guys regain consciousness over the next few minutes, and Sir Reginald is, I mean, if
anybody wants to give him like a healing potion or try to stabilize him.
Kick him until he wakes up.
Yeah, that's
fine. I'll give my healing potion on him.
Cool.
All right, get up.
So roll 2d4.
Your dad said you don't get your inheritance if you don't get up.
Oh! I have done 6.
So now you have 6 hit points.
Is this the short rest that we're taking?
Plus 2, right? For normal healing potion?
2d4 plus 2, yes. So 8 hit points.
I need to free my goat here.
Guys, don't forget about me.
I'm conscious now, right?
Oh, yeah, you're conscious.
I immediately book it over here, and I pull out my dagger, and I'm going to start sawing at the rope.
That is a 10-foot drop.
Oh, I'm not going to do that. You know that.
We're going to carefully move.
Is there a pathway down? Is there some, like...
It looks to be a pit that was, like, dug with magic.
All right. So there's no handholds or anything.
I mean, it's a fairly scalable wall. Like, it's not a super high DC if you want to climb down.
Cool. Yeah, I'm going to do it.
Give me an athletics check.
Sorry, Petunia, you're in a hole.
Oh, I can't get you. I'm sorry. That is 11.
Unacceptable.
You make it about halfway down and then just kind of like plop, but you don't take any damage.
Okay. I die from that. I won't
get you. Yeah, right. You're like, you try to like scurry down, you get like really excited halfway down, and you just kind of like onto the ground. But you're fine.
I like jump up and look around to make sure no one knows.
Nobody's looking at you.
Yeah. Petunia's still restrained. It's like, me.
Yeah.
I'm mostly excited to see how she's going to get out of the hole with that goat.
Yeah. I haven't thought that far. I'm just excited.
Clearly.
My goat. So I run over to Petunia. Yeah, I'm like crying. I'm excited. I take out my dagger and I start like sawing at the ropes.
About freaking time.
All right, listen, Petunia.
So, Petunia is now free and kind of like nuzzling you and like.
I'm like hugging her and crying.
Yeah.
And then I realize I'm in a pit.
It's an emotional moment.
Yeah. Totally.
It's an emotional moment.
Mistakes and some creepy. Sextical.
They're not glowing anymore. Remember?
They're not glowing.
That's good.
That's true.
No longer glowing.
I think this is what the occult call a goat scene.
Oh, you're fired again.
I'm sorry.
All right. I yell up to everybody. Hey guys.
Hear that?
I kind of need some help.
Sounds like a halfling.
Goats climb.
Not this one.
Of course it
does.
All goats climb.
I'll bop over and give her a hand up.
Aww. They wouldn't call them mountain goats if not. I mean, is it a plains goat?
An aqua goat.
No.
I mean, I have rope. I can tie it around Petunia and try. Can I do that?
Yeah,
we can arrange it.
I'm going to stay right up here. I'm just having fun looking down at these guys.
I'm going to tie the rope around Petunia and then toss it up to.
I want my skiff, man. I miss it.
Petunia's very small. Petunia's only like.
Before you come up, can you pull those stakes out of the ground?
Yeah, okay.
While you're there.
Can I do that? I pull them out of the ground?
Give me a strength check.
Can we deface
I can't
the...
pull them out of the ground. 13.
Yeah, you can pull them out of the ground. Yeah, that's fine.
Cool, yeah, I pull them out of the ground.
I just like making y'all roll for sure.
Cool.
Typical DM.
Yeah.
I have Petunia back, guys!
Can we take a short rest?
It's nighttime, isn't it?
It is getting to be nighttime.
Yeah.
You could take a long rest, but you're in a kind of weird area. You're very close. You're like
600 meters. You're 600 meters. Away. I mean,
let's head back.
Let's go back to the.
Y'all can take a short rest and like recoup yourself and like spend an hour.
After. I'm gonna spend a hit die.
Short
rest is 20 minutes. What is it, 1d4?
I thought it was 10. Who knows?
Something like that. Rules lawyer?
Do you have your cool bard thing where we get to do extra hit die if you...
I do. You get an extra d6 to teach you to heal perfect
now. Can you just sing me that song of rest?
So, this is a song about
a short rest.
A tiger that I used to know. The kind you can see his stripes, but you know he's clean.
Oh my god.
It goes like... Holy diver. No, he's clean. You see what I mean?
It's a nice song. It's a nice song.
And that's all I know of it.
So you just sing that over and over again for the entire...
Ride the tiger. It's another part of it.
That's it, yep.
I'm still getting used to this.
All right.
But you guys feel better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait, so what is it? One extra D6?
Yeah, you're all an extra D6.
You guys are ridiculous.
Zombie. Pick your glasses while you're at it.
Yeah.
Maybe we can get you like a...
Zombie, I'm over here.
Like some leather, you can tie them on in the back so they don't come up. Like,
no, I need to be free to...
Live free or die, baby. I get it.
Free.
All right, so that was Song of Rest. Everybody's healed up. Should head.
We love that. We should go talk to the big scary mushroom man.
We should, yeah. I tie my rope around Petunia's neck so I can lead her like a dog.
Perfect. Wait, what do we know about this magic?
What?
We have the stakes with us.
Roll an arcana check. Anybody who's interested in the stakes.
It's not going to be worth it. Yeah, I can't do it.
19.
He might be able to.
Okay. You can tell that the just from like the emanating magic from it, because they are still kind of like warm. You can tell that like something about these stakes was meant to, like, something about the spell cast on these stakes was meant to transport whatever was tied between them with the portal that the cultists summoned and left out of. It was meant to bring the goat with them. Hmm. But they could not complete.
So you were telling me there's
his creepy new tattoo glow when he touches the stake?
Does that mean I did that? I mean, were you the one that nailed the cultist? Or no?
No, I hit the stake.
So it was a team effort then, because if you pierced the stake and you nailed the cultist, they did not finish their ritual. And they
archers!
Yeah, archers. Cool. So you guys take your rest and make your way back to Ruggins Mine. And you make your way through the you hear yapping echoing through the mine and as you walk deeper and deeper into the mine, you head into the antechamber of the Mushroom Kingdom. And the purple light is not purple. It's actually not as bright as
last time we knew it was red, right?
I mean, it was a bright, violent red, and now it is a very soft, deep red, and it is pulsing very slowly, like a very weak heartbeat.
Oh.
And as you walk down the steps, you see lying on the steps is one of the Mycenids, Hendrix. And he is split in half. His top half is kind of like splayed, and his long legs are at the bottom of the stairs, and he's oozing this like deep blue liquid. And he kind of like weakly shakes his head, and he goes, "This isn't cool, man."
I'm gonna try to. Can I make a medicine check to see if I can hold him long enough to talk to us?
Yeah.
Nat 20.
Oh,
nice.
Yeah, for sure. You can talk to him.
So I'm just gonna bind up his top half.
Yeah. Yeah.
And squeeze.
Okay. Yeah, it's kind of like it's oozing a little bit, and then it kind of flows down, and he's like,
"I've never tourniqueted a whole body before. I'm sorry."
It's like,
what happened here?
Oh man, they'll grow back eventually, I think, but like. Here's a guy, and he's down, it's not good.
Like a bad guy that's not good down there?
It doesn't seem real good.
Well, we better go investigate. Come on!
Yeah, I'll hurry on.
Yeah, okay. So as
my
you...
My dog's down there, man.
Yeah, straight up. As you guys... run down to the Mycenids. Let's grab this map again, where did I put it? As you run down to the Mycenids, you see a lot of the Mycenid Guardians, and they are strewn everywhere, dead or dying.
Oh
And as you run into the antechamber, you see...
He's carrying a head.
Oh, yeah. The, there is a dark elf, brandishing a sword.
Oh my god, is it Nisha? I mean, did we...
It is not Ellesandra. It's not Ellesandra. There is a dark elf wearing all this, like, black, sleek leather armor. And he is holding, from what you can tell, the head of Baron Zurich von Erlu. And he is in combat with Shangri-La. What do you do?
Charge.
No!
Can we think about this for a second?
Stop doing that every time!
Charge, I mean, what do you ask me to do? I mean, obviously he's a bad man.
Can I get one arrow off before you charge me? One! Let my arrow charge, and then you immediately in its wake. Follow, yeah. Like a cavalry.
I would like to do investigation, perception, whatever. I just want to check and see if I can see my dog anywhere.
Okay, yeah. Roll perception check.
Cool.
But he's just going to be...
That's going to be...
You're pretty good at perception, I think.
I have no... Yeah, but not as good.
You haven't done
for my initiative.
Oh.
That's going to be a 9.
You can get a surprise attack.
Yeah, I mean, like... You can't tell how alive... I mean, you can tell how alive he is. You can hear his barking from Shangri-La's chambers, but you can't see him, no.
Cool. Good enough for me.
You can't tell the state he is in. Anybody else want to do anything?
I'm going to lead Petunia over here, like, into this little alcove thing.
Okay.
And I'm going to go, sit. Okay. Sit.
Get all the barn mother.
Lay down.
Okay, great.
And she lays down, and I leave her there and come back over. I say, stay. And then I come back over again.
And I think we're going to roll for initiative.
Cool.
All right.
Oh.
Oh, boy. 15 to 20.
17.
Okay.
17.
Nice. Roll off.
9.
1.
Okay. Ten to 15. Ooh.
12.
11.
Roll off.
1. You got it. 13.
Okay. And that's everybody, yeah? That's everybody. Great. Sir Reginald, you're up first.
Yeah. Foul vermin!
I'm guessing you're charging.
Oh, yeah! Only I was on my horse.
Yes, attack me.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes, he says. 21.
That'll hit. Roll damage.
That would have been terrifying if it did not.
Thank God, he says. 5.
Okay.
And he's Large dead! Damage. Wow!
Yeah, he's already dead.
No, but I'm going to take his attention off of
it seems like you're certainly doing that. Minka, you're up.
Ooh, I'm gonna cast Chill Touch on said person.
Okay.
Elf. Dark Elf?
Dark Elf.
Not Ellesandra.
They all have the same name
now? Oh, man.
It's my spell casting modifier, right?
Yes.
So 17 will not.
No! Oh boy, that is that's not gonna do it. And that means it's his turn. And he, having been struck in the back by a knight, is gonna swivel around, and he is going to take a couple of strikes with his sword. I assume a 26 will hit.
Probably.
Yes, on that.
All right, so you're
gonna... It's okay, you got Shangri-La for your backup.
Yeah. You're gonna take 7 damage.
You got it.
Okay. It is Shangri-La's turn. And Shangri-La is going to take his massive tree staff and
kind of point it at the dark elf.
And hurt him real bad.
Yeah, that's what that looked at, right?
I was afraid that he was going to be like, Shangri-La's like, oh, you guys got this.
I turned the volume on the dark elf down.
Just remembered I got somewhere to be. That was a lot of dice you just rolled.
Oh, God.
21, 2. So more than 5?
So he's going to take 40 damage.
How's that look?
So you see Shangri-La, he takes his massive tree and he points it at the dark elf, and this like black ooze kind of like shoots out of it. And it seems at first like it's slime, but it appears to be like light.
I'm wearing lace here. Cannot be black.
And there's this like this black like necrotic energy shoots out of the roots of this tree and sort of blasts onto this dark elf. And you can see it like starting to eat away at his armor, and you can see his skin start to like shrivel and age. And while he is being struck by this bolt of energy, he just kind of shoves it off of him, and his skin kind of returns a little bit to normal-ish. And he does not look very happy about that. Ewain, it's your turn.
Ewain's gonna go take a little bit of cover over here. And then I'm going to draw my bow.
You got it.
It's okay, you hit Reggie, and we don't.
Yeah, no. You know how many times I've hit
him
by accident?
That's gonna be an 18.
18 hits?
Nice. That's what we like to hear.
You'll make the steel wall.
It's gonna be 9 points of piercing damage.
Okay.
That ends my turn.
Okay. That brings us to Avi.
So I am going to actually take this. Okay. I'm going to take this opportunity to run by him. Give me my opportunity attack. Miss? Okay. I'm going to speak as a free action to Xanadu. Hey, are you up? Are you okay? What's happening?
There is no time for speaking, little one.
Okay, then I'm going to take my... within 5 feet of him. I'm going to take out my rapier, and I'm going to look this dark elf in the eyes and see what his metal is.
Yeah.
17? 18.
18 hits!
6, 7, 8, 9.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'm gonna land a good hit on this dude.
You land a good hit on him, and he, like, looks at you right in the eye, and he points at you.
Uh-oh. True strike!
Did I not do that?
Nobody
right?
is dumb enough to use the <first one. laughs> No villain of mine will be stupid enough to use that godforsaken spell.
Who hasn't gone yet?
It is Roscoe's turn.
Roscoe's got Bardic Inspiration.
I love it. Inspired. Thank you for believing in me.
Roscoe! Give him the old dick special!
They fade after.
Oh, they fade, yeah. Sorry.
So I'm going to sneak around that corner instead and do a bonus hiding action. Sure. Just see. Ugh, 10.
Okay.
He's already in melee.
You feel fairly still.
Alright. Enough for advantage on a attack.
So he's in melee with two of us, so you can still get
That's the sneak attack, but
yeah.
Being hidden gives me advantage on the...
Nope.
No, alright. 19 to hit.
19 will hit.
Nice. So that's 5 plus... Oh, 11 damage total.
Excellent, nice. Yeah, you stick him. And he
points at you. No. Did he break it?
No, he just drops it.
Oh, good. I can recover it after the fight still. Yay!
Yeah.
Don't worry about it. I haven't fight yet.
So is that the rest of your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. Sir Reginald.
I would like to step on his arrow.
You can buy me more, rich boy.
Damn.
I would like to... I'm going to aim for the hand holding the head.
Okay.
Interesting.
To make him drop said head. I don't.
Okay.
It's a two. I mean, it's a six, but it's a two. It's not a one.
Okay. Minka.
I would like to run to, like, here.
Okay.
And I would like to cast Witch Bolt on.
Whoa!
Witch Bolt?
Yeah. Roll to hit.
Elf.
You did save me with dinner, Pope.
Yeah, you deserve a answer that one.
Nope. 16.
Not gonna do it. Okay, it is the assassin's turn. And he is going to turn into a puff of smoke and reappear right behind Roscoe.
What the fuck? I'm gonna learn how to do that.
And he is going to put you in a headlock and try to grapple you down.
Oh.
But he's gonna roll a nat 1 on his attempt.
Yeah, but I get to choose. It doesn't matter because you.
Oh yeah, you get to
roll terrible.
And that's gonna be his turn. Shangri-La. Shangri-La is going to turn into mist.
Yeah.
Come up behind him.
Reappear right here. And he's going to take a big old swing down at him with his tree. He is going to do.
You're going to feel this.
Yeah. Jump. Just
move.
Bowel shaking.
20 damage. So the tree just comes down on the assassin, on the dark elf, and the dark elf just stands back up and pushes the tree up and slides it off of him.
This guy rules.
Can I tell if we're out of our depth? Other than all the obvious.
I mean, you're pretty out of your depth.
Can I tell if it seems like this guy's
That's what makes good stories, though.
Hmm?
Can I tell if it looks like this guy might hire me as an intern?
Teleport? We will see about that. That is going to be Ewain's turn.
Ewain's going to take a few steps this way. Yeah, he's going to come over here. And take a shot.
Okay.
With his longbow. That's not going to make it. Yeah, 11.
Nope.
Rough. All right.
Okay, Avi.
All right, Avi is going to No, I don't want to use that action yet. I'm just going to hit this guy. I can get within 5 feet.
Okay.
So I do that. I'm going to hit him again.
Ooh.
And nice. I do hit. And I do 5 damage.
Okay. Anything else?
Aha!
Oh, you definitely hit him.
Good. And I want to make it cool.
It's super cool.
Thank you.
It's so cool. In fact, the Dark Elf is like, super cool.
Validation.
Okay.
All I want to do is surprise them.
That brings us to Ross.
You gotta get some of those like sunglasses that go over glasses like old people have, and then you can do like cool things. I'm going to disengage as a bonus action and do like a cool backward somersault over here away from him.
That's super cool.
And shoot him with my bow and arrow.
Okay.
Little dingus. So that's 14. I'm gonna use my Bardic Inspiration.
Okay.
Nope, I do not hit him.
Okay.
But I am gonna roll up my shirt sleeves and kinda wiggle my magical brand at him.
Ooh.
Give him a little eyebrow waggle. and then take the rest of my movement back over here.
You're doing the old ring around
the taunt. Pole. Sir Reginald.
Seaver Deaver. Can I charge and tackle him?
Yeah, so what this is a strength check. So you would roll, or it would be athletics opposed to his athletics.
With strength.
A d20
what?
Plus strength, and are you proficient athletics. In athletics? Yes. So it's a d20 plus strength and proficiency.
16.
Okay. Yeah, you tackle him, and he is knocked prone. And that is your turn.
Yes.
Okay. Great. Minka, you're up.
Can I run and hide behind Avi?
Yeah, you can.
Cool.
You gotta, are you using your action to hide, or are you just, like, getting behind?
I'm just gonna, like, get behind.
Get behind. Okay, cool.
I can get behind.
Yeah, I can get behind that.
Oh, God. Can I cast Acid Splash on him? Or is that gonna hit?
I would assume that would.
Big screen. Yeah, that's
it. It's two creatures of your choice, I believe. Yeah. So, yeah, you can focus your Acid Splash on him.
Okay,
we went over that again.
More about Acid Super Soaker.
Yeah, Acid Super Soaker, Acid
that's
Fountain,
right?
You can arc it and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, so,
fine.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit him with Acid Splash.
And that's a dexterity saving throw?
Dex saving.
Acid Water.
That's a fail.
Two.
Nice. Ding. Great. Okay. He, prone, is going to turn into a puff of smoke.
Oh, spot that prick.
Do I have his head?
Yeah, you knocked the head out of his hands. And so the head of Baron Zurich von Erlu is on the floor.
Where it belongs.
And the assassin... Does a 17 beat your armor class, Roscoe?
Yes.
He grabs your wrist and lifts you up.
Motherfucker.
And he looks at the brand on your forearm. And he looks into your eyes. And he drops you.
Ow.
And he turns into a puff of smoke. And that's where we'll pick up next week. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to our sponsors. Thank you to Devin Berry for joining us tonight. And we will see you in 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Check us out on Facebook.
Like, subscribe. Are we still live? We're still going? Yeah, okay. Like us, subscribe, follow us on Facebook and Instagram and TikTok and all that shit. And if you don't, I will summon a sea hag to curse you with technical difficulties or impotence.
Okay. It's one or the other. There's no...
Yeah.
It's like a already... monkey's paw thing.
What if you already got one of them? Asking for Dane.
It's technical difficulty.
Yeah, it's true. Your dungeon master has been Michael Peavy.
Awesome. Great work, everybody.
Yeah.
That was fun. I fell down again. Very good.
I feel like getting knocked down is just going to be a thing that happens.
Roscoe is kicking my ass.